Got your door!
My pal, too. He's a friend for you.
My pal, too. He talks. He says, ring toss on his head. He's a robot, pal. Yeah!
He talks, plays hoops. Simon says, his nose glows and he throws. My pal, too. Batteries not included. From Toy Biz.
I was in a half show and making a surprise. Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtle pies. Fresh from the sewers to you. Their minds are delicious. You know that's true. Because they're filled with mutagen goo.
That's vanilla pudding, dude.
They've got the tastiest, flakiest, greatest crust.
Even better than on pizza.
And it's green. Like us. Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtle pies. Fresh from the sewers to you. Radically sweet.
They can't be beat.
And there's a free turtle sticker inside. That's neat.
New from Boston.
Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtle pies. Fresh from the sewers to you.
You're on Fox, man. We'll be right back.
It was a typical summer day. Three kids in search of fun. But as they stepped through this doorway, they entered into the battle zone of the future. A world where high-tech weaponry will determine their fate. The world of Laser Pro 9000.
Warning, beware of incoming fire.
Laser Pro 9000 each sold separately. Scanning hit counter, firing light, pulsating hit indicator. With Laser Pro 9000, the boys were victorious. The weapon of the future, the sport of the 90s. From Gloob.
I got claws. I can use them.
Who said that?
Mutants must rule.
Did you see that?
Optic blast fire.
They all said that. They all talk.
Introducing Marvel Talking Superheroes and X-Men.
This is my...
It excels, too.
Three separate voice sound activators let you control what they say.
Die, Spider-Man.
And do.
I want to eat your brain. Spider sense tingling.
Marvel Talking Superheroes and X-Men. Each sold separately from Toy Biz.
And now back to our program.
Me on foot? Impossible. And I'll race you to prove it.
Now, twins, this is no way.
I've had enough of this utterly ridiculous, pointless bickering. Goodbye.
I never thought it could happen. But the can-do twins have split up.
Steady, old chap! Whatever has gone wrong with the bed machine?
It's time to
eat a snack?
No, no. It's time to tell a joke?
Everything is falling apart around here, and we can't even communicate with the twins. If only they would start working together again. And the only way to get them to work together is to offer them a challenge they can't refuse.
What kind of challenge?
I say that's not a bad idea, Wendy.
The challenge of building a new racing machine for a race around Neverland.
If everyone builds his own bike for the race,
twins will get caught up in the contest and join forces to build the ultimate racing machine.
Which means they'll forget this silly tiff and be friends again.
Of course you realize no one will be able to build a machine that can beat the...
I hope we get the twins back together before bedtime.
John, we got a problem. The spring thingamajig you designed is stuck.
No, it isn't. Look.
You're right. It's not stuck. But you are. You'll have to go slightly faster than that, Toodles, if we're going to win the race.
But why don't I do the running? And can you do the steering?
Because that's slightly the best division of labor.
Look, Nick. Mine is almost ready.
Here we are, the Neverland Rocket. The fastest machine in Neverland.
Hey, you stole my design.
Your design? That's my design.
Well, at least they're talking again.
Stutter and flux, Peter. You can fly. Why bother building a silly whatever that is?
Because I am Peter Pan, and I am going to have the very best racing machine in Neverland.
You don't know the first thing about building machines, you silly...
But I know who does. Ah, Mr. Jukes. I was hoping to find you in it.
Peter Pan. I'll teach you to come nosing around my workshop.
Now, Seaman Jukes. Whoa. I am here to discuss a wonderful opportunity.
Opportunity? The only opportunity you can offer me is a seaman's chance to chop you into middle-sized pieces.
Suit yourself. I shall go back and inform the twins that Billy Jukes is afraid to challenge them.
A challenge? What challenge?
Oh, nothing much. Just to see who can build the fastest racing machine in all of Neverland.
Build the fastest racing machine in Neverland?
But since you're not interested...
No. Wait, tell me more.
Grills and grills, Peter. Why don't you just steal the whole ship?
We're not stealing this gear, team. We're just borrowing, right, Peter?
Right. Now, let me see. Only one last thing we need.
Fiddle-Marie! Why do I even bother?
Peter Pan, this is the craziest thing you've ever done!
Aw, come on, Tink. This is a perfect plan. What could go wrong?
Calimera! Shoo scuttle cooks and soup! Now cooks and scuttle shoo!
You're on Fox, man. We'll be right back.
Bowling Greens? I'm history.
Wouldn't it be great to go back?
Yeah.
For more graham cracker crunch? Another sweet taste of honey?
Yeah.
And that golden moment called breakfast?
Yeah.
Golden graham!
The part of your complete breakfast you'd like to have twice.
You're not just good, you're golden.
doctor, my belly aches.
You've got butterflies in your stomach.
You got a Charlie horse?
Operation.
A broken heart, of course.
Operation.
Remove the pieces and collect your fee, but don't touch the sides.
Operation.
I'm the doctor for you.
Operation.
G.I.
Rolling into action, it's the battery-powered G.I. Joe Battle Wagon with motorized four-wheel drive. Battle Wagon's motorized gun shoots 8 rapid-fire missiles. The four-wheel drive Battle Wagon, each sold separately with rapid-fire gun. Figures sold separately. Batteries not included.
Go, go. I can make my baby laugh, can you? I make her feel better when she's blue.
Magic bottle baby toddler and newborn. When you press the buttons, you can choose whether they'll laugh, cry, drink, even burp.
We give them their dinner, it's true. But we love them the best when they're through.
Excuse me.
Magic Bottle Baby Toddler and Newborn. Each sold separately. Batteries not included. New from Tyco.
And now back to our program.
Meow.
Stand aside, Seacook. I need this cauldron more than you do.
You have need for lots more than that when Cookson get through with you.
Ah, now see what you've done? Stand aside before something else is broken.
Ha! I break you next, Peter Pan. Then I smother you in grape leaves.
Peter's gonna need some help.
Or I may be just fricassee you. Hey!
My shipmates may not understand why I've jumped ship to help Peter Pan, but at least they'll thank me if this keeps you from dishing out your vile victuals again tonight.
Jukes, that is you?
Enough of this, Billy Jukes. We've got a race to win.
Aye, and an escape to make before Captain Hook discovers what we have done.
Tighten the topmast line, gentlemen, start here. And if you don't make up, be sure to move faster than a gallon of Virginia Longlick. I'll separate that greasy mustache from your foppish face.
Aye, sir. On my way, sir. Right up the sky ladder as high as you please.
Avast, you free-floating flounder! There's no rigging to carry on!
Oh, Viking Georgia. Absolutely. Begging your pardon, Captain, but the port sky ladder is missing.
And that's not the worst of it. Some jackbooters cut a 10-foot square out of the mainsail.
Aye, and hark to the crow's nest. The tip of the main mast is gone. Along with Johnny Bowsprit. Gorlin, Brimston, let a mast sail and sprint. And the helm as well, all phantomized. What cousining is this?
Egorra, Captain, to be sure, the great cook and Billy Jukes are also gone to mystery. Oh, they're nowhere to be found.
I'll strip the sticky muscles from their spindly bones and scoop the ill-used brain from their...
Where'd they go? He's night, yes? No! Yeah! Ah, get me down!
Offer me an explanation for your ankle bone antics, you stumbling saltcore squire, or I'll...
Explanations? I don't give you stinking explanations. I tell you what happened. Billy Jukes, him take launch, jump ship, join up with Peter the Pan.
Jukes has jumped ship with... Peter Pan! On the soul of my perfectly mannered, dear departed mater, I swear I'll track down those traitorous Tom Peppers and cleave them from brisket to brain pan with this very hook!
Don't deny it! You stole my design!
Oh, but you won't
get away with this,
you sneaky thief.
Oh, dear. This race was supposed to bring the twins back together, not drive them further apart.
We can't have a race anyway, Wendy. Not until Peter shows.
Make way for the Neverland Flyer.
Peter, watch where you're going.
Mr. Jukes.
Aye, aye, Captain Pan.
Let the race begin.
Short, your cretaceous caterwauling and do a devil's damage on the lot of you.
Everyone, see your racers and flee!
Hurry!
Weigh anchor, Mr. Jukes!
Anchor aboard! Time to sail!
You're not going nowhere, me! Give me fine!
You're slightly wrong, Smee!
I get you, Brad, for sure! Stay still till I slash you right!
I should say not!
Blast it!
Those confounded hobbledy boys have escaped us again!
Not all of them. This deserted scum will make fair meat for my hawk.
Hold, Captain. My seemingly traitorous actions were but a ruse, a plan, a trick to end all tricks, and a path that will lead your hook straight to the heart of Peter Pan.
Now listen carefully. This is the route of the Great Never Race. Past the Neverberry Field, along the Mermaid's Lagoon, and then the race finally ends right back here, where Wendy will judge the winner. Just a moment, Mr. Bell. I'd like to build a racer, too. But, Wendy, you have to be the judge.
Yes, you're the only one we trust.
Very well, since you've asked so nicely. Gentlemen, to your machines!
Great! I can't wait to get...
Wait, Peter! Don't leave me behind!
But how did you ever escape Captain Hook, Mr. Duke?
It was as easy as tying a sheep shank. That old one-handed tripesman can't keep a fair hold on me.
Lie away, my good little Billy Boy, and lead Peter Pan to a most vile rascal's end in my buccaneer.
I'm gonna beat the pants off of you, you sneaky car design thief!
Quiet, Wind! Time to get ready, get set, and go! Poor Michael doesn't have a chance. Peter's way ahead.
That mongrel brat, Peter Pan, doesn't possess a dog chance.
At what, Captain?
And continuing his valueless life, you gown-necked galley drowner! Man will never survive my trap in the Neverberry Field.
I don't know which I hate worst, staggering around this cursed dry land, or climbing to the top of this lovely berry bush. Oh, we not be here long, Mullins. Soon we drop that catch pan, pull catch in, and please, Captain Hook, all at the same time. Aye, and speaking of Peter Pan, here the little sluggard comes.
Look out, Peter!
Can't catch me that easy.
I can't!
All of us, we've netted the wrong fish! I don't know which is worse, walking on this cursed dry land or being dragged through it.
Drag through it, I be sure.
On account of those dumb pirates, we've been bushwhacked. Peter, if the pirates attacked us in the Neverberry Field, they're bound to attack us at the Mermaid Lagoon.
Let them, Tink. They can't stop the Neverland Flyer! Zoons and zooters! These logs are scattering!
And brain pan for fair!
My Jenkins, Martha dear. I think we've made a small error. Don't worry, Jake. I'll just put on some extra steam. Thanks.
This is all
your fault. If you had watched where we were going, we never would have...
My trikey broke.
Don't worry.
Oh, we'll do what, Jen?
Use parts from our machine to fix your trikey.
No, I can do the work by myself.
But when? If we don't work together to fix my trike, I'll never win the race.
Michael's right. This is a job for both of the can-do twins.
Gordon, Brisbane, at the race near this end, Pam still lives. Signal Jukes to stifle that boy's ambition for speed. At once!
Aye, aye, Captain.
Time to finish this farce, Pam.
Peter, watch out!
Sorry you had to leave, Jukes.
Oh, look, hammer and tongue! If you want to think just well, you must endeavor to do that thing entirely by yourself.
Off with you, Captain Codfish! I've got a race to finish!
And I have you to finish, boy! I'll slice you up like a French fillet! You're infamous!
You're as bad as Cookson's cookbox. All the steam you blow, Hook.
I'll exterminate you yet, you miserable boy!
That rotten pirate wrecked the Neverland Flyer! And now no one will ever win the Great Never Race.
I'm not so sure about that.
As Admiral Anchovy would say,
Gordon Brimstone, Michael has won the Great Never Race.
But how?
Another mission successfully completed by the Can-Do Twins.
You're on Fox, man. We'll be right back.
Yo, video game dudes, talk to me!
This is Game Genie!
Brokaloo!
The awesome video game enhancer for your
Nintendo Entertainment System.
Attach it to most of your video games.
Double Dragon 3 or
Super Mario Bros. 3.
You can go to any level.
Live forever.
Jump higher.
Make your own effects.
And get radical firepower.
Go to any level, jump higher, stay bigger, live forever. Game Genie, the radical video game enhancer.
Now on video, it's Disney's Rescuers Down Under. What's your favorite part?
First you got trapped, then the boy saved them, just took a knife and got two ropes and made three. So then Cody fell off the cliff. Ah, and then the bird was like, he got the Cody flying.
It's Disney's Rescuers Down Under on video cassette, rated G. Are you ready for the adventure?
Yeah, you bet, yeah.
And now back to our program.
Hey, it's your pal Chris Leary, and this Sunday morning make plans to hang out in the Fox Kids Countdown pre-Thanksgiving Day blowout. All right, who's tossing frozen turkeys? It's going to be fun. I feel kind of woozy. Lock in your radio Sunday to...
I'm Howie Mandel, this is Bobby Jenrick, and welcome to Bobby's World.
That's my line.
What?
Welcome to Bobby's World.
Oh, I'm sorry. Well, we've got a great show for you today.
That's my line.
What?
We have a great show for you today.
Okay, Mr. Smarty Pants, you tell me what to do.
Dance for the people.
Until I finish feeding your gee golly little brothers there now yet.
All right.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. I told you I could beat you, losers.
Okay, Mom. Come on, Roger. Let's go play with Derek.
2, 3, 4, 5? You flipped 6 of them.
Peter, what are you doing? Can I play?
Go away, dweeb. This is just for me and my friends.
I could be a friend.
No, you can't. You're my brother. Now get lost.
I'm in my own yard. How can I get lost?
Go fly a kite, Bobby.
I don't have a kite.
Take a long walk off a short pier.
I can't. I'm not allowed across the street.
Then just go climb a tree.
That's what I like about Big Brothers. They have so many great ideas. I still can't see. What are they doing?
Thanks a lot, dweeb. You've just ruined the best Caps game of my life.
Wow, Caps! That sounds like fun! I want to play too! Can I play Caps with you, Derek? Can I?
No way! You don't know the first thing about playing this game.
Oh, yeah? I do too! I know the first thing, and the last thing, and all the things in between.
Do not!
Do too!
Do not!
Do too! Do too! Do too! Did you ever notice that the less you know how to do something, the more you have to say you do?
Okay, shrimp. Prove it!
Well, you pick up the ball.
There's no ball. It's a slammer, dweeb!
I wasn't finished yet, okay? You pick up the slammer, then you,
You don't even know that you use the slammer to hit the Caps, do you?
I was gonna say that next. See? I do too know how to play.
Forget it, Bobby. Come back when you're big enough to play with something besides your food.
Oh, Derek! Lucky! I've got all your Caps.
You give me back those Caps now, dweeb! Those are my special collection of secret ancient Caps!
Wow! Secret ancient Caps! The name is Bond. Bobby Bond. Well, it looks like the Slaminator has found me.
Hold it right there! These are my special Caps. I don't want your dweeb cooties on them.
Bobby's got dweeb cooties.
Yeah? Well, who wants to play with you guys anyway?
Freeze, dweeb!
Uh-oh.
Let's see you do that again.
Okay.
Whoa.
Uh-oh. Am I in trouble?
You're on Fox, man. We're the Roughback.
Juggernaut.
But waiting are the X-Men.
Evil mutants.
Wolverine flashes claws of steel, while Cyclops turns on laser power.
This city is speed limit.
And the giant Apocalypse is powerlifted by the mighty Colossus.
Lost again, Magneto.
X-Men and Evil Mutants, each sold separately from Toy Biz.
The Perfect Game has great characters like Disney's DuckTales with Uncle Scrooge, Huey, Dewey, and Louie. They need to get to the bank before Magica and the Beagle Boys get the money. Then there's Disney's Baloo from Tailspins. You can help Baloo pilot his plane to Sea Duck while dodging disaster and the evil pirate, Don Carnage.
Game.
It's Disney's DuckTales and Tailspins games from Tiger. Batteries not included, each sold separately.
What's the cool new game everybody's running to get? It's Thin Ice.
You're on thin ice. You're on thin ice.
Take the tweezer in your hand and pick a marble from the sand.
You're on thin ice. You're on thin ice.
Quick, put the marble right on top and pack the tweezer before they drop.
You're on thin ice. You're on thin ice.
It's a game of luck and skill. One remove, take a spill. Place your marble cool and nice, but watch out.
Thin ice.
Thin ice, but trust me, it's cool.
And now back to our program.
Am I in trouble?
In trouble? No. I hate to say it, Dweeb, but that was a great shot. You're a champion.
I am?
Yeah, you're a natural.
I'm a natural?
Come on, Bobby, fire it in there. Slam it time. Okay, Shrimp, listen up. From here on out, I'm gonna be nice to you because you're good at caps, and that could pay off big time for me. In fact, I'm gonna be so nice to you that I'm gonna be your manager.
Gee, thanks, Derek. I don't know what a manager is, but I think I'm gonna like it.
All right, step right up this way. Who wants to take on my super slamming little brother? I gotta admit it, Dweeb. You're the Prince of Caps. Nah, forget it. You're not the prince.
I'm not?
No, you're the king!
I'm the king. I'm not the prince.
Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for the boy formerly known as Prince!
Yo! You know, once I was the prince. Baby, now, don't you know? Yeah! There, now I'm the king.
You're the greatest. You're the best there ever was, Squirt.
And you're the best big brother manager that a little brother ever had. And I still don't know what a manager is, but Derek's the best.
Which reminds me, this is for you. 10 caps.
Well, what about the rest?
The rest is our stake. As manager, I get all the stake caps. Understand?
No.
Okay. Okay, then from here on out, we'll split everything. 90% for me, 10% for you. Fair enough?
Sounds fair.
It's the least I can do. After all, you and I are best friends now.
Yeah, best friends. There really is no other like my big brother. Him and me will always be a pal to one another. I used to feel rejected, now I get respected. Derek is my best friend.
There really is no other like his big brother. It's plain to see that him and me were made for one another. It's truly undisputed.
It's so nice to be included.
Derek, he's your best friend.
He'll take me everywhere he goes. To the mall, the rides, and the
big kid shows.
I do something bad. He takes the blame and saves my name.
No other like his big brother. It's plain to see that him and he were made for one another.
It's really no illusion.
There's only one conclusion.
Derek, he's your best friend. It's truly undisputed.
It's so nice to be included.
Derek, he's your best friend.
Oh, pinch me, I must be dreaming.
Well, gotta go, Bobby. You stay here and practice. We've got a lot of games to win, bro.
I'm having a terrific day, Roger. I'm a champ, I have 10 caps of my very own, and Derek just called me a bro. Isn't that great? Let's go tell Jackie.
Hi, Bobby. Wanna play caps?
I don't know.
Come on, Bobby. It's just a friendly game.
Okay, but I thought I'd warn you. I'm a natural.
I'm a natural, too, but I've been practicing 5 hours a day, Bobby. My mother says that talent is 90% perspiration and 10% deodorant. Sorry, Bobby. Just wasn't your game. Like my mother says...
Jackie! You and your mother are... You watch too much television! I've lost all my caps. Now I'm not the champ, and Derek's not gonna want to be my best friend anymore. What am I gonna do? That's right, Roger. Derek has plenty of caps. I'll borrow some of his and win back the ones I just lost. And I'll be a champion again, and Derek will still be my best friend. Uh-oh, Roger. Kelly and Mom are watching TV. Got to get past them and get into Derek's room without them seeing me.
Wow. Like, that cat burglar is totally fine.
Well, gee golly panky derbs, he's coming down that ceiling like a spider, don't you know?
Yeah, just like a spider. The burglar alarm hasn't been made that can't be cracked by Bobby the Spider Bandit. Swibbly, I owe you one. Shh, Roger. We don't want anybody to know we're in here. We gotta make a clean getaway.
I see you're back, Bobby.
Well, sorry, Jackie. I'm gonna have to win back all my caps.
Okay, sure. Losers first. Too bad, Bobby. Now remember, what I'm about to do has nothing to do with our relationship. It's just a game.
Oh, no! If Derek finds out I lost all his caps, he won't be friends with me for the rest of my life. Maybe even longer.
Cheer up, Bobby. There's always another game. As a matter of fact, my mother saw one advertised on TV. A big tournament this weekend. You could...
That's it! I'll enter the tournament, win back all of Derek's caps, and we can still be best friends! I'll be the champ again, you'll see. I've got to start training for that big tournament so I can win back all of Derek's caps.
I can help. I'll be your trainer. My mom saw a whole show on personal trainers to the stars. Usually the place they start is with liposuction.
Super personal trainers.
Welcome to my superhero training camp, Bobby. Get set for the 50,000-yard dash! And you call yourself a superhero? You can't even outrun a speeding bullet! Drop and give me 20,000!
Why am I doing this? I'm only gonna play caps, not be a superhero. But what if I don't win the tournament, Jackie? What if Derek finds out the truth? I've gotta practice!
Family secrets come out sooner or later, usually between 3 and 4 on Oprah. Everyone cries and yells, but sometimes you get a movie deal out of it.
If I don't win as many caps back as I borrow from Derek, he won't ever be my best friend again! And Mom and Dad will be mad at me! And Kelly will think I'm bad for taking Derek's stuff without permission! Oh. If I lose, Jackie, it's gonna be awful! No one will like me and I'll be all alone in the world! I don't need them. I don't need anything. Except Webley. I don't need anything in the whole world except Webley. And teddy bear. Yeah, that's all I need. Webley, teddy bear, and my hockey stick, and a mask is all I need in the whole world. And my favorite dustball. I need that. And this. I can't do without this. Whatever this is.
Hey, that's mine. Get a grip, Bobby.
I wish I could be sure I was going to win that tournament!
There are no guarantees in life, Bobby. Except on infomercials, of course.
Jackie is starting to scare me.
The truth is your only friend, Bobby. Tell your parents your story. If you explain the whole thing to them, they'll probably understand. They'll respect you because you told the truth.
Yes! And Mom and Dad will probably want to give me a reward for telling the truth! Mom! Mom!
Rein it in. Just a gee-golly card-playing moment there, young man. Can't you see that your father and I are playing cards with the hole is there? No, yeah.
Queen of trumps. I win. Thank you very much, Martha.
Oh, Howard, we're down 1,000 points. Now, honey, what did you want to tell Mom?
Well, Derek wouldn't let me play caps. Then he discovered I'm a natural, and then I wasn't a king or a prince or even a natural, and I lost all the caps, so I borrowed Derek's, but I lost them too. And if I don't win them back, Derek's not going to be my best friend anymore.
Now, Bobby, it was wrong of you to take Derek's things without his permission.
I know. But don't you want to give me a reward for telling the truth?
Now, listen here, Mr. Manzi. Telling the gosh golly truth is its own reward, and it does not excuse stealing, don't you know?
You're going to have to pay Derek back for every cap you lost.
Yeah, and I want you to march up to Derek's room right now and apologize to him.
Okay.
Yeah, and let that be a lesson to you, hon. Gambling just doesn't pay, don't you know?
Howard, don't be a cheese log. Ante up. This is our chance to win our gee-golly steak back.
Sometimes parents can be very confusing people. I hope Derek's not too mad at me, because when he's mad, he's like a monster.
Don't leave. Stay and have a bite to eat. I'm having lunch with the boy who stole my caps. Say, wasn't that you? It was almost worth losing all my caps so I could have such a delicious snack.
Hey, Dweeb! Throw me the ball.
Derek? I gotta tell you something.
Okay, hurry up. I'm busy.
Borrowed your caps and then I lost them, but I'll pay you back. I really will. I just don't know how. I'm sorry, Derek. We can still be friends, can't we?
We might be able to work something out. First, swear that you'll never, ever take anything from my room without asking me first.
I swear.
Now we can talk about how you're gonna pay me back.
Yeah, okay. I wanna pay you back. I'm gonna give you anything of mine that you want. Anything!
Okay, I'll just take your hockey card collection.
Not my hockey card collection.
You said anything.
Okay, anything but my hockey card collection.
Then I want your stamp collection.
No! Not my stamp collection! Anything but my hockey card collection and my stamp collection. No! That's my lucky yo-yo! And anything but my hockey card collection, my stamp collection, or my yo-yo. Anything, anything, anything!
It's mine, it's mine. You said it was mine, Weeb.
Are we still best friends?
Don't be stupid, we're brothers.
You give me back my yo-yo right now! Mom! Eric took my stuff! Mom! Mom!
Ladies and gentlemen, let's put our hands together for our special guest tonight, Fabio!
Hey, thank you for having me on the show. I can't wait to see it.
But it's already over.
Oh, okay. Bye.
Bye.
You're on Fox, man. We'll be right back.
Spaced out! Max back! Blacktron Lego Maniac! Finds his way through cosmic night, guided by his landing weight. Tires roll, he's got the knack. Blacktron Lego Maniac! Blazes trail through outer space. This dude saved the human race! Max! Blacktron Lego Maniac!
The Blacktron Collection, new from LEGO. Each sold separately, batteries not included.
It's fast, fast relief for the cartoon blahs. There's no speedier relief. So zoom in and tune in.
Stay tuned, sir.
Watch Tom and Jerry Kids Show Saturday morning on Fox.
And now back to our program.
I'm almost ready to power up.
Hold up here, Bobby. What's going on here?
Bobby, maybe you should spend some time with your father.
Spy Tech, case 109. A stranger is on your block. With your Spy Tech rear view glasses, you've got him in sight. You leave a message in code. Your partner uses his Spy Tech watch to decode it.
He's at the movies. Where'd he go?
This'll find him.
You placed a trap. Use the Spy Tech invisible detection kit to follow his footprints.
Cancel the plan. They have Spy Tech.
Spy Tech. High-tech equipment that works. New from Titan.
Yikes! This fruit roll up has stripes!
Where did they come from?
Funny you should ask.
Bravo!
Follow me.
Wow.
I swiped one stripe from a zebra, and one from a kite, and one from a tie, and even one from a fish swimming by. I swiped a stripe from everything you see, and put them on this special green roll-up magically. Swipe stripes. Now you can get one free inside boxes of fruit roll-ups. 1,001 taste adventures.
The Tom and Jerry Kids. Gotta be there where all the action is. Tom and Jerry Kids. The Tom and Jerry Kids show. Big tail, little tail, chasing all around. It's a cat and mouse game that never lets down. Well, there's Spike and Tyke, Doopy and Dipple. Come on and have some fun, it's oh so simple. Talking about the Tom and Jerry Kids. Come on and be where all the action is. Tom and Jerry Kids. The Tom and Jerry Kids.
The Tom and Jerry Kids News Show.
TXF, Fox 29 in Philadelphia.
It's the White Castle dudes doing the Casimir. Wow, this new chocolate taste is so great, you deserve the award. Yay!
For me? Hey, it is me. Thanks, everyone.
Now, you can get your own award from Sunny that's also a musical bank. Free, with two proofs of purchase from marked boxes of new Cocoa Puffs.
Pencils, everyone? Action. Can your TV pass this simple screen test? Do you get cable TV with Showtime movie exclusives like Pretty Woman, Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, Back to the Future 2? Plus, smash hits like Glory, Steel Magnolias, Look Who's Talking, and Showtime's original Knockout Entertainment? Only cable gives you this, and right now, installation's just $9.95. Okay, here's an easy one. Do you like to save money? Right now, Showtime is on sale. Just call this number. And you know what else you get if you order now? Sports, world events, and great family viewing 24 hours a day. Just call 1-800-253-9600 now. Get cable installation for only $9.95, plus get big savings. Showtime. We entertain you like no one can. Call 1-800-253-9600.
Chewing bubble yum bubblegum. And this is Reggie, a land roving turtle from the island of Galapagos. Both are big, but only one is soft. Big soft chunk bubble yum keeps it popping.
This is a chunk of super soft bubble yum bubblegum. This is a loud thumping, tune pumping boom box. Both are known for blast. But on the yum is the fun that never blows out.
Big mouth busting bubble yum keeps it popping.
You've got you drinking with Quince.
Quince, Quince, five times more fun. They drink their bottle four, five, and the fun's begun. They drink and wet,
just like real babies do.
Then their magic diaper show numbers for you.
Now there are Quince who really drink and wet, with magic diapers that show five numbers when they're wet.
I love taking care of all of you.
Drink and wet Quince was special for five magic diapers, bottle, and hamper. Other accessories sold separately.
And now back to our program.
Incredible! My tomato shark will wreak havoc on San Zucchini's harbor!
Call, Doctor! We'll have the whole beach to ourselves! All that sun, sand, surf!
Not to mention stupidity! I don't want the beach! I want San Zucchini! And after San Zucchini, San Francisco, San Diego, and even
San Malibu! Oh, gnarly!
This is cool!
Surf's up!
Awesome!
Well, here we are, folks. The very first annual Tomato Task Force Beach Party.
Hey, we forgot Sam the Sham.
Nah, I've been here since dawn. Sam the Sham never misses a party.
Excellent! You realize what this means, Igor?
Yeah, you rotten ship. The Tomato Task Force is throwing a beach party, and they didn't invite us.
Correct.
Correct?
What? Never fear. We shall be joining their little beach blanket boogie.
Ready, set, surf!
Relax. We aren't going, but we are sending our representative.
Oh, man.
Wow! Bubblegum!
That looks like fun.
It is. I wish you could join us.
Oh, but the water is too salty. It would turn me into a tomato. Sometimes I wish I could be a normal girl and go surfing and swimming.
A pretty little Harry.
Maybe you can. This waterproof super sunscreen should make you immune to the water's salt content for a while.
Oh, I will try this later, Chad.
And I've got the pepper just in case.
Oh, 1,098, 1,099, 2,000. How about that 20-mile hike, Will Borovich?
No, thank you. I don't want to go anywhere right now, Mary Jo. Until after I eat.
Boy, that man has a real appetite.
Be careful, Chad.
Nothing to worry about.
You sense it too, FT.
Forever, Phoebe.
Something is out there, and it's not one of us.
Oh, man. What happened to the waves? Hey, where's that weird music coming from?
Sam, is that your boombox?
No, it's not even turned on yet.
That music, it sounds like... Oh, no, it can't be!
It is! Actually, to be precise, a tomato shark. And the biggest one I've ever seen! Actually, it's the first one I've ever seen. But who's counting?
Paddle, Chad boy, paddle!
That's one big tomato skin.
There's no way he can get away. That kid's a goner.
Tomato power, don't fail me now.
Comrade Chad has caught what they are calling a big wave.
And the water's so clear, I can't even see it.
For Super Shabby?
I'm okay, FT. Thanks, Tara. I needed that tomato boost.
I was afraid you'd be caught by that terrible tomato shark. I always get emotional at times like this.
That proves you're more person than tomato.
Oh, thank you, Chad.
Glad you're okay, Chad. A tomato shark here in San Zucchini. This is a job for the Tomato Task Force.
It's tomato trumpet time, folks.
Sam, go up to the crow's nest and take a look.
Oh, oh!
Penthouse, please. I got some good news, and I got some bad news. We thinking.
That's the bad news?
No, that's the good news. That's the bad news!
Oh, no! They're doomed!
Kids Network. We'll be right back.
Look what the Quints have now.
Wow.
Quints with lots more fun. A vanity with mirrors for everyone. They look so pretty when you style their hair.
Now let's put them in their rocking chair.
They got their own puppies and a pool for
vanity for $5. Quince cycle pole and other accessories sold separately.
One, two, one, two, three, four.
Give me a break. Give me a break. Break me off a piece of that Kit Kat bar. Give me a break. Give me a break. Break me off a piece of that Kit Kat bar.
That chocolate crisp taste's gonna make your day. And wherever you go, you hear the people say,
give me a break. Give me a break. Break me off a piece of that.
Break me off a piece of that.
Break me off a piece of that Kit Kat bar.
Don't I know you? Bo knows literature.
Bo knows physics.
Bo knows geography. Bo knows Shakespeare.
Bo knows band.
Nice drum. Bo knows philosophy. What are you looking at? Nice toes. Bo knows calculus. Bo knows all this stuff because he stayed in school. Don't be stupid. Stay in school.
And now back to our program.
This is Weekly Wipes, live and unrehearsed from...
Wow!
San Zucchini Harbor. Where the annual San Zucchini Down to the Sea and Ships Parade is about to begin. It has been alleged that a tomato shark is lurking in these quiet San Zucchini waters.
Excellent! I've eliminated the tomato task force, and now nothing stands between me and my conquest of San Zucchini.
Where tomato sharks and flying tomato fish from the dark depths of the sea have unleashed an incredible attack on beautiful San Zucchini Harbor. Yuck! Tomato war is... heck!
How terrible! Uncle Wilbur and the tomato task force are gone! And now the tomato sharks are destroying San Zucchini Harbor!
It doesn't get much worse than this.
We need help. The Army, Navy, Marines, and Cub Scouts are helpless. Who's left?
Maybe this is something.
Hugh Quark, shark hunter, for hire. Cheap.
Hugh Quark lives here.
Not much of a place. You think this guy's for real?
Of course he's for real. Now, what brings you landlubbers out to old Quark's cabin,
Tomato sharks are attacking San Zucchini, and we found a note in a bottle that said you were a shark hunter.
Tomato sharks, you say? Oh, that's bad. Really bad. Really, really bad. What's a tomato shark?
It's like a real shark, only bigger and uglier. And it's round and red, sort of like...
like a tomato. I get the picture. Come on inside.
Person.
I am the world's greatest shark hunter. Why, I was even swallowed whole by a giant white shark once off the Bermuda Triangle. You might say I know sharks inside and out. Don't suppose tomato sharks will be any more trouble than real ones.
This is awful.
Yeah!
Where could these
evil, despicable, tomato shark-like creatures have come from?
Need you ask? The Tomato Task Force, completely in my power. Nothing can stop me. Nothing.
I still can't believe it, Tara. Uncle Wilbur, gone.
Yes, Chad, but we must not give up hope. The tomato shark that swallowed their boat was awfully big.
Yeah, really big. So maybe they're still alive in there. Like Geppetto and Pinocchio and Monster the Whale.
Yes, and we must rescue them.
Ah, these be dangerous waters. If you're a tomato.
Mines!
Tomato mines. They can smell a tomato in the water from 1,000 yards. Explode on impact.
Who's driving the boat?
The wee little feller's a natural seaman.
Onward, FT! Let's find the tomato shark!
Seen anything like this since come to think of it, I've never seen anything like this.
It's the giant tomato shark we have to get.
Chad, I sense something coming.
FT senses it too.
There she be. Give me a hand, lad.
We got him!
Jack, I think it has us!
Where's Tara? The tomato mine! It's homing in on Tara! The tomato mine is after Tara! And there's nothing we can do! FT! Swim faster! This waterproof super sunscreen will protect Tara from the salt content of the sea. For a while.
Oh, thank you, Chad.
FT can't get away from the tomato mine!
Thank you, FT, for saving me. You're welcome, but you saved me first.
I hate to interrupt this touching little scene, but I think we're all gonna need to be saved. From the Titanic.
Are you sure?
Hey, let me get out!
It's Uncle Wilbur's boat.
It's awfully quiet.
The door's locked.
Let's see, baby.
Uncle Wilbur!
Chad boy, are we glad to see you?
Good going, lad.
Now we are free. Time to take out this tomato submarine posing as a tomato shark.
Magnificent! Don't you agree, Igor?
You've out-awesomed yourself this time, your seaworthiness.
Yes, yes! Soon, Zanzucchini will be reduced to fish food. And no one!
one can stop me!
No one.
Whoa! Oh, bummer. Really bad picture.
Quark and the Tomato Task Force, loose
and ready to sink your sick scheme.
Oh, someone's going to sink, all right, but it's not me.
Don't worry, it's only water.
And quick dry of cement. Shouldn't that be whom?
Enough with the grammatical gourmet. It's time we got down to serious business, like the final attack on San Zucchini. Is my final assault team ready?
Ready, my commander. Victory shall soon be yours. And the fertilizer will be ours, shaken not stirred, of course. Follow me, my brave comrades. We sail into history.
You. What do you suppose they have in there?
Tomato rockets. These will complete the job of sinking San Zucchini beneath the sea.
We have to stop them somehow. Maybe... That's it!
What is it, Chad?
The temperature. Tomato rockets are notoriously unstable when hot. If we raise it enough, the tomato rockets will self-destruct.
It is getting very warm in here.
It is getting warm.
That's edible too.
Too hot.
Much too hot. What's happening?
This is not good, Igor. If it gets too hot, the tomato rockets will explode.
The heat is dissolving the cement.
Let's go, me buckles!
I am suggesting the ship we jump before it's too late. This.
Doctor, sir, you should know that,
Quiet, Igor! I'm trying to think!
But, sir...
Not now! I'm trying to turn off the heat! They're escaping! Stop them!
The tomato rockets.
What about the tomato rockets?
They're rocketing.
I must remain calm. I am in charge. I am the master of the situation. I must not... From Fort Lee, New Jersey, writes, how do you do your special effects? Is it dangerous? Does anyone get hurt? Can I try this at home?
Sure asks a lot of questions for some dude from New Jersey.
Silence. Of course, you shouldn't try any of these tricks at home, but I will now demonstrate your basic special effect as we drop this tomato on Igor.
That's me. Freeze frame. Now that we've stopped it, I step out from under and we can continue. See how easy it is?
Who says you can't get good help anymore?
You're on Fox, man. We'll be right back.
I see you in the box that rolls.
Kellogg's Corn Flakes presents Cornelius Rooster. Nothing gets you crowing in the morning like Kellogg's Corn Flakes, part of this complete breakfast.
Hey, there's our star. Want a star in a comic strip with me? Free with mail-in coupon on specially marked boxes at Kellogg's Corn Flakes.
And now back to our program.
Hey, what's up? It's Chris Leary, and tomorrow morning the Fox Kids Countdown turns the ripe old age of two. It's going to be nonstop partying with games requests, action figure updates, hot Marvel info, you name it. Tomorrow morning, turn your radio on with the Fox Kids Countdown birthday bash.
This is going to be great.
Sure, you've got places to go, people to see, but why not pop over to Burger King and find out how to join the Kids Club?
Details are specified in the Kids Club newsletter.
So if you're just hanging out, why not pop into Burger King?
You've got a friend to hold on to, so make it fun, whatever you do.
Boomer Kid Big, Jaws and IQ, it's the Kids Club gang and they're waiting for you.
You can get one of four Kids Club action figures when you buy a kids meal at Burger King. The Burger King Kids Club, just for fun, just for you.
Fellas, meet Micro Keebler. Everything he touches turns smaller.
Smaller? We're already elves, sir.
Watch this cookie.
Wow!
It's an elfkin. New Keebler elfkins. We take elf-shaped cookies, fill them with fudge, and Micro shrinks them.
Elfkins are the funnest cookies ever. Mr. Micro, you're a genius. I gotta shake your hand.
Elmer!
These are totally awesome! You can eat in one bite.
New elfkins from Keebler.
See all the fun they get in Piggsburg Pigs. When they're out splashing, laughing, they know who to watch out for. Those wolves wish they were having Piggsburg Pigs. Piglets like making mischief, wonder what they're up to. That duck would love to miss it when they do what they do. Pigs go forbidden places, then they wish they'd stayed at home. Now they're lost in outer space. It's Piggsburg Pigs!
Fox Kids Network. We'll be right back.
Corn Pops, please. Breakfast was an hour ago, Mr. Johnson.
A cheap watch, I guess. So I overslept. I want my Kellogg's Corn Pops. Stay cool.
How about some nice prunes?
Prunes? Try Corn Pops. Oh, like sweet popcorn. You always want more. But thanks to this prune queen, I'm starving for a bowl, and how am I going to get my pops? Ah! I love what you've done to your hair.
Why, thank you. Well.
Kellogg's Corn Pops is part of this complete breakfast.
I gotta have my pops.
I see you in the box that rolls. High five!
And now back to our program.
The skull of Kronos is mine.
Similar to the mud I had to slop through when I discovered the skull of Kronos in the Forbidden Zone.
Who cares, Hamhocker? Such a bore!
Oh, Mr. Proudfork, I'm so thrilled about your generous gift. It bought a whole new wing for our museum.
Well, when you're a red pig, why hog it off? Join me in some swill, Mr. Bocconi?
You don't mind if I do.
See the Bacon Brothers.
And I know why. He's too much competition, isn't he, Remy?
Au contraire, Mon Pretty Piggy. I'm sure I invited him. Make sure no uninvited pigs get in, especially those named Bo, Pighead, and Portly.
These pit chickens will make bacon strips out of anything that tries to get in, sir.
Perfect.
Sorry I let you talk me into this. I don't think Rembrandt wants us to come to the party.
Hey, relax. It was just an oversight.
Yeah, Rembrandt just forgot to invite us.
What's that? Are you all right?
There's been a robbery at the museum. You've got to get me to the Proudfork party. I've got to tell Mr. Bocconi what happened.
Look at all the fancy pigs.
Yeah, they're gonna be a fancy dinner.
But how are we gonna get in?
That's how. Come on.
Excuse me. May I see your invitation?
We don't have one, but this is an emergency.
Tell Rembrandt it's the Bacon Brothers. He'll let us in. Remember to take Rembrandt off the Christmas list.
We've got to get in to see Bocconi. Come on. All clear. Set the ladder up against the wall.
Right.
Okay, start climbing. Where's the guard?
Well, at least the guard made it over the wall.
Come on, we gotta find him.
Whoa, look at all those pork chops.
Soon we'll be eating like pigs. Hey, where are you going with those trays? Take the trays over there.
Dinner time!
You ate it. Let's eat. Pig out time!
Does this mean we don't get to eat?
It's a good thing that tree broke your fall.
Yo! Lorelei! Have you seen Mr. Bocconi?
Oh, Bo, you're here!
I would have been here sooner if I was invited.
Remy!
Where's Mr. Bocconi?
He left.
Well, what about Professor Schweinstein?
Ditto.
There's Professor Hamhock!
Maybe he can shed some light on this.
And when the gems are placed in the skull, it has the power to turn pigs old.
But who would do such a terrible thing? And why?
Something tells me he don't need an invitation.
Who are you? What do you want?
You, Proudfork. You will pay me $1,000,000 or your fate will be the same as the gods.
Stay back, girls, while I take care of this clown. You're not going to turn my dad old.
Then I'll turn you old.
Don't bother. One old proud pork in the family is enough.
You have 48 hours to drop the money at the Hogfish Cannery on Pigman's Wharf. I'll be waiting. Remember, if you don't pay, this will happen to you.
I'm afraid that fiend's going to turn me and my father old.
Don't worry, Remy. It'll be okay. I'll stay with you and see that nothing happens.
You will?
Some guys have all the luck. I wish it was me who was threatened.
Now look at the bright side. If that kid Creep doesn't get his money, then Rembrandt will be too old for Lorelei.
One sticky pizza supreme with eggshells, apple cars, dried corn cobs, and three-day-old banana peels. All the watermelon rinds.
There must be some way I can get Lorelei away from that pompous proud pork.
Hey, I got it. Capture that masked maniac and you'll be a hero and win Lorelei back.
You can't be serious. It's too dangerous.
No, Portly's right for once.
He is.
I just need a few props. And tonight, we can spring a little trap for that skull-clutching fiend. Doesn't sound like fallen fish to me. I see you messed up again.
Don't worry, we'll get him next time around.
Here I come again. He's right behind me.
Guys, where are you? Did we get him?
No, but I've got you.
Fox Kids Network. We'll be right back.
Last time, the Honey Nut Bee was changed into a donkey. Will the wits change him back?
Not while I'm eating my complete breakfast with Honey Nut Cheerios.
Please change me back.
Not until you give me another bowl.
Now?
Let's see, you were a bee.
No, a bee that flies. No, a honey bee.
Oh, a gummy bee.
Now you can get free gummy bees in specially marked boxes of Honey Nut Cheerios.
There's new action in the universe from Marvel Superheroes.
Spider-Man! Dr. Octopus.
I'll bend Dr. Octopus in half, Captain America. No time, Hawk. My shield will cut him down to size.
Meet your doom, Surfer.
Not so fast, Doom. Take him, Surfer.
Marvel superheroes are each sold separately from Toy Biz.
Look what the Quince have now!
Wow!
Quince, with lots more fun. A vanity with mirrors for everyone. They look so pretty when you style their hair.
Now let's put them in their rocking chair.
They got their own puppies and a pool for fun.
Here's your cycle, let's go for a ride. They're adorable!
We love to play with all of you.
The Quince vanity for five. Quince cycle pool and other accessories sold separately.
And now back to our program.
Who knows? Maybe Lorelai goes for all the pigs.
If not, you could date a grandmother. Some sow, huh? Ooh, you're getting mean in your old age, Bo.
We gotta go see Professor Hamhock. He must know a way to reverse this curse.
Quick, in the car, here they come.
I'll jump him, Huff. And I'll fricassee every one of them.
Not yet. We're waiting till we get a carload of oinkers. I want to really pig out. Hey, I finally get to drive Bo's car.
There's only one way to make your friend normal again. An ancient book may tell you how to reverse the curse. You'll find the book in the Temple of Kronos in the Forbidden Zone.
The Forbidden Zone!
This old map will help you find your way.
We better get Dottie to help us. She's good at reading maps.
Oh, I just love helping you babysit the three little pigs, Lorelai. Lorelai, I feel so safe with you.
Don't worry, Remy, baby. Everything will be all right. Let me get you a hot cup of slop.
That Rembrandt is such a...
That masked maniac has poor Remy so frightened. And we're all out of slop. Remy could sure use some. I'm gonna go to the store.
Ah! Oh, it's only you.
Ship. We're gonna be the first pigs on the moon.
Yeah, and you can be our rocket pilot.
Sure, I'll pretend to fly this thing.
Get ready. 3, 2, 1. Blast off!
What happened?
Piggy and Pokey sent Rembrandt to the moon.
I see little Piggy's been playing Rocket to the Moon again.
Hi, guys. I didn't expect to see you so soon.
You have to come with us. It's an emergency.
Oh, okay. Rembrandt, get down from there and watch the piggies. Lorelai should be back soon. Oh, hi. Who are you?
Keep on this Temple of Kronos does a lousy job.
According to this map, this corridor leads to the center of the temple.
Guys, I think we found it.
You sorry excuse for a wolf. How could you get stuck in a spare tire?
Let's get them pigs!
I should have brought my swimsuit.
I'll see how deep it is. Maybe we can walk across.
And then again, maybe not. I gotta hand it to you, Quackers. You sure know how to outsmart fish.
Well, youngins, that only leaves one way to get across.
This was a great idea, even if it was from an old timer.
And nothing's gonna stop us now.
You spoke too soon, Pighead.
Don't worry, Donnie. I'll save you.
I'll save you.
What a knuckle hamwich.
Hang on, Donnie.
Your rescue has arrived.
You got the hit? Only one of us can save her.
Says who?
Fellas, look!
No!
Nice move, Dottie.
We made it. Now, let's get that book.
Hey, there they are, Huff.
Come on, we'll swim over. Wake up an appetite.
The Book of Kronos is behind that door. We have to get this sphere up there.
Nothing to it.
We have to place it with the green side down.
What difference does it make?
If the red side is down, the ceiling drops.
Oh, that's a good reason.
And then we get to eat.
The curse will be lifted.
Yeah, and I won't be old anymore.
Sure. All we gotta do now is find the skull.
Dangerous than jaywalking on the hogway.
Look, Huff. Here comes lunch.
We'll chow down in Piggsburg. Hit the gas, Pigman. He's headed for Piggsburg.
With all this rushing around, I hope that creep didn't forget to bring the skull with him.
Bingo! The skull's riding shotgun.
Don't worry, Bo. Once we get that skull, we'll turn you young again.
Why not join us for dinner? Our menu consists of a tender pork roast and a wrinkled side of pig jerky.
But I'm not hungry. Help!
Oh, no. We got some hungry hitchhikers back there.
Don't worry about these fuzzy furballs. You just get that skull.
I wonder if this is how Mario Hamdretti started.
I hope you like this pot. My mother's.
We're losing them.
Not for long. Take a shortcut through the hogwash. Bo, Donnie, are you guys okay?
They're doing fine, but they got cooking water up to their necks.
We gotta get that skull before Donnie and Bo are pork stew.
Toss in one mashed garlic clove, some minced onions, a tad of parsley, and a little rutabaga.
Rutabaga? Rutabaga doesn't go with pigs. You're doing this all wrong.
We are?
Afraid so. Cooking pigs is a fine art. Let me show you how.
Well, okay. But no funny stuff.
First of all, the water level's too low.
What do we do?
Hop in the pot. Uh-oh, now the water level's too high. Better get Bo out of there.
Yeah, thanks. My feet were starting to wrinkle. Come to think of it, they were already wrinkled.
Hang on, guys. We'll get rid of those wimpy wolves.
How are we gonna do that?
We are not. This bump is...
Rats! Here goes another dinner.
I don't know about that. This soup tastes pretty good to me.
Now, let's get the soup. Mr. Skull, but we got the car. Hit the brakes. While you're taking a donut break, we're gonna see who you are.
Mr. Bacconi!
Gee, if you needed money that bad, I would have lent you some out of my piggy bank.
Aha! Uh-huh. Got the skull!
Now we can get everybody back to normal. It was really neat to see the guard and waiter dancing when they were turned young again.
Yeah, but Bo was kind of cute when he was old.
Hey, what about me?
You want to be old? That's a snap.
Yeah, and it's easy, too.
Ta-da!
Fox Kids Network.
We'll be right back.
Blark!
A new peanut butter crunch egg with... an even yummier peanut butter cereal than ever.
Peanut butter? Peanut butter!
Blark! A peanut butter weasel!
Peanut butter! Yeah, yeah, peanut butter! Better peanut butter! Peanut butter! Peanut butter! Peanut
He's
butter.
Crazy for the better peanut butter flavor!
He's eating it all!
Tut-tut! He's just excited about a better taste! And news like that you don't keep under your hat!
Yeah, yeah! Peanut butter crunch!
Now it's even better and part of a balanced breakfast!
Fox 29 in Philadelphia.
Got my skis shined up and a stick of juicy fruit. The taste is gonna move ya. Take a sniff, pull it out. The taste is gonna move ya when you pop it in your mouth. Juicy fruit is gonna move ya. It juices soft, it gets right to ya. Juicy fruit, the taste is gonna move ya.
And now back to our program.
Ghostbusters Castle Meal is a blast with Slime and Mint toothpaste and a toothbrush, or bubblegum toothpaste and a toothbrush, or a real Ghostbusters hairbrush, or a real Ghostbusters soap dish with soap. There's one included in every Castle Meal. You can collect all four at White Castle.
Sun Fruit Drinks. Fruity, cool, adventurous.
It's wacky, it's fun, it's a whole lot of fun. Why is it to be fun?
It's a real good.
Wacky contestants, messy games, the Fun Car Grand Prix race, and a crazy chase to win lots of prizes. Now here's the guy that puts the fun in Funhouse, Pat Sharp.
But only just. Me and the twins had just been in this restaurant. We couldn't believe what a good time we were having until this gorilla walked in and actually asked for just a lemonade. So the guy behind the counter charged him £10 for a lemonade. Then he had five more lemonades at £10 each. And then he walked out the door. And on the way out, the barman says, "We don't get many gorillas in here." And the gorilla said, "At these prices, I'm not surprised." And this is the Fun House! Your day's been as good as ours. If it hasn't, we'll make it even better with Melanie and Martina. How you doing? Well, I think their whole family's in. That's the biggest cheer they've ever had. Bring on the teams! And here they are, Melanie and Martina, together. How you doing?
Fine, thanks, Pat.
Who have you got?
Okay, I have Ewan and Eve. They come from Stanford, and they both attend the Stanford Endowed School. Yay!
And Melanie has for the Reds?
I have Lee and Aaron, and they're from Lurgan, and they attend the Lurgan Junior High School.
Oh, right. So it's a big hello to Eve, first of all. How are you doing, Eve?
Hi, Pat.
Hi, nice to see you. Your nickname is what?
Titch.
But you're about the same as you, and you're not a titch at all.
I am.
No, you're not. What's your ambition?
To be a lawyer.
Okay, so you better behave during this show. Everybody at home there, because she'll get you otherwise, and you'll be in all sorts of trouble, and in the law courts. Anything happen to you that's funny?
No.
It says here your life's boring. Nothing funny ever happens. We'll sort that out on this show. You'll have a great time today. Welcome along. Ewan is with you. His nickname is Tweed, because your surname is Tweedy.
Yes.
Okay, nice to meet you. Your ambition is?
To be a zoologist.
A zoologist. Well, I did take the twins to London Zoo once, but they didn't let them out, kept them there, because they thought, you know, behind the cage and stuff like that. Wish you luck. Hello to Aaron Graham Nelson, who's from Northern Ireland. Nickname?
Steel.
Steel.
Yeah.
Funniest thing that ever happened to you. Now, this is a good one. You'll like this.
I was playing fireman at home.
So fireman Aaron as opposed to fireman Sam? Yeah.
And I jumped out of an upstairs window and broke my legs.
You mean there was no ladder or anything? You just went, hey!
Yeah.
What a funny thing to do. Well, you will enjoy the Fun House then. And you sang Wild Thing in front of the whole school.
Yeah.
Could you do a little bit now in front of the whole of the UK?
Wild Thing! You make my heart sing!
Oh, I think that's great, yeah! Brilliant. I was going to say stick to jumping out of windows, but that was very good. Lee's with you, whose nickname is?
A lawnmower.
Why's that?
Because I'm fast running.
Fast runner?
Yeah.
What's that got to do with a lawnmower?
Don't know.
Oh, right. Well, we'll have to ask the people who nicknamed you. The funniest thing?
We were over on our holidays and my dad was dressed ready to go out and four fellas came along and threw him into the pool.
Oh, right. He must have loved that, I should think. Can you say, it's a cracker pat for me?
It's a cracker pat.
She's got the right accent for that. Welcome to the Fun House teams. Good luck to all of them. So here's how we play Funhouse then, guys, and girls for that matter, because there's two guys and two girls. One from each team will be racing their way through three fun-filled games, each one worth 25 points to the winning team. From that, we bring you guys back here. We ask you a bonus question. They're also worth 25 points. Then it's the Fun Cart Grand Prix, which, as you well know, the girls bring on the carts, and then the teams take over and race around our Funhouse three times. Then a trip through the Funhouse for the team with the most points, perhaps picking up on the fabulous power prize. We do have the biggest prizes on this show as well. So for game one, we thought we'd go off to the Funhouse farmyard. If you saw me standing against a lamppost, it would be a case of Pat-a-pillar, but this is Caterpillar. Come on, girls! Is my little friend. I want you to have a little chat with him because he sounds just like the twins, doesn't he? Squeaking away, moaning away, going,
when are we going to the disco, love? When are we going? You want to dance?
Sorry, girls. They're just getting dressed up, okay? Now, the reason they're dressing up their teams is because their teams will actually beat real-life caterpillars, and it'll be their job to get across all the gunge in the farmyard and grab out a cabbage, like this. Now, the cops can't use their hands because this is Funhouse, so we want you to get gungy. So, use your teeth, get the cabbages back inside the bowls. Red bowl over here, yellow bowl over there. And, of course, that noise. So, today's key game, which means the runners-up will also get points. Points mean prizes on this show because the big prizes are at the end. 60 seconds is the time limit. Caterpillars at the ready. Stand by to crawl through the mud. Get the cabbages on your marks. Get set. Go!
Yeah.
Have a good time?
Yeah.
Loved every minute of it, did you? Okay, sorry. She's pushing me out of the way here. Shall we count them up then? Okay, let's have a look.
Okay, we've got 1, 2, 3, 4.
Four very bald cabbages. Now we need 4 or more for the red team. Here's the news.
We got 1, 2, 3, 4.
For each, that means it's a draw. I bet they can't wait to turn into butterflies. Let's rerun the fun!
Yeah!
So even Lee getting messy and getting 25 points each as well. Yeah! Okay, Aaron and Ewan, I've got a question for you. Boys' question, stand by the buzzers. Wish you luck, it's also worth 25 points. Use those intelligent glasses of yours, all right? Beep, beep. Here we go. Wriggle Wiggle is the game we played. What is a cabbage white? Reds.
It's a butterfly.
It is a butterfly. 25 points. So, 25 yellows in the lead. The Reds from Northern Ireland with 50. Okay then, our second fun-filled game features the two lads as grave robbers as we go off to the graveyard at midnight. Come on. Wow, it's pretty eerie over here and very smoky as well. And this is my little skeleton. He sang the song, Ain't Nobody. You know that one? Yeah. Okay. Right. Well, inside these coffins, as you can see, are really horrible skeletons. If you have a look at this one particularly, this is the gungiest one because there's a snake and there's blood and there's gunge and there's ghoul and there's all sorts of things. It'll be your job inside 45 seconds to get out different parts of the skeleton. In other words, the head and the torso come as one, then there's a couple of arms and a couple of legs. There's also a scarf and some gloves, because when you're a skeleton, it gets very cold out there in the graveyard. Come across here, dip the various bits inside the bone cleaner. From there, you rush it across and you hang it on your pole. As many parts as you can get, the one with the most parts will be the winner. Sorry, I was just coughing. Right, on your marks, get set, go. You've got, do not move, because we must count up how many different parts and whether or not you made the whole skeleton. You've done very well, you old boneheads. Turn around here, look at this. You got a nut to go with that bolt. Oh, you have, this is your nut. Right, fair enough. Okay, so how are we going on?
Okay, we got 3 on there.
How do you know? Come on, let's see.
Well, okay, we've got the one arm,
yeah.
We've got the one leg, yeah. And that arm just fell off last minute because he just knocked it, and we've got the body as well.
So it counts?
Yeah.
Okay,
so we've got 4.
Three?
No, 4.
4! 4!
4! 4!
A twin that can count? Goodness me. Don't worry, we'll see how many arms we've got here. This game is quite armless if you're playing it at home.
We have one arm, body, that's 2, mm-hmm. Another arm, that's 3, and one leg, 4!
So, we get ourselves yet another draw. Let's rerun that fun, skeleton! Another 25 points apiece! Here's a question just for the girls then, from Bonehead. Good luck to you, worth 25 points if you get it right. Now, the correct name for the bone is humerus. How do we more laughingly know this bone?
Yeah. Funny bones.
Funny bones, right! Yeah! Okay! So now we have the scores of 75 points each. It's still a draw at the moment.
Yeah! You're on Fox, man. We'll be right back.
Twizzlers. Ah, a sea of mouth-watering Twizzlers. Chewy. Tastes so fruity. I love it when it twizzles. Twizzlers makes mouse happy.
Graham snack in honey, cinnamon, and chocolate.
They are number one today. Teddy Grahams are here to stay. The best go.
And now back to our program.
Right, I'm going to take you all now on a little trip to the skiing resort of St. Van Rits. And if you don't know how to make a snowball sundae on a Wednesday, you're about to find out. Come on! Yeah! So here we are in this fabulous skiing resort. Well, it is pretty fabulous, actually, because if you ever look inside here, you will see that there are snowballs hanging from the top. Apart from the fact that there's also lots of snow in the bottom. That's the snow in the bottom. These are the snowballs, which will be pulled down one by one and pulled out as you get in there wearing all your ski gear, okay? Now, Snowball Sundae, as you well know, is an ice cream. Everybody knows that, okay? So as I put on my ski gear here, which is the legendary... Oh, I could put the ice cream on my head and put the hat on. Well, either way, that's what you wear on your head. This has got ice cream and lemonade in it. Mmm, absolutely delicious. Even though it's a weekday, you can have a snowball sundae. It'll be your job inside 1 minute to pass out as many of those snowballs as you can. You collect them, bring them over here, dip them inside that, then dip them inside the coconut, then whack them inside your hat, then take the lemonade, which is real lemonade, and I'll prove it to you, and then pour that in. And of course, you've got exactly the same as this then, haven't you? Bits of ice cream, bits of coconut, bits of lemonade, and a completed snowball sundae. The one with the most snowballs in your little Pyrex dish after 1 minute is the winner. Just start you off there, give you a bit of fair and square stuff. On your marks, get set. Cheers, big ears! Game. Everybody did particularly well. Do you know, for a moment, you almost looked like you were enjoying yourself. Only a very short moment, mind you. Right, how many have we got then, completed snowballs?
We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6!
Okay, 6 is good. Now, we need 6 or more for the yellows to get some points. It's 75 each, so it's an important time. Go.
Okay, we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7!
Oh, yeah! The yellows are the winners! Let's replay the Sunday!
Yeah!
At last, an outright win for the yellows. 25 points! Yeah! Okay, I have a question now for you and Aaron. The boys' question, so wish you luck. This will really make the scores interesting, seeing who gets it right. Snowball Sunday was the game. Snowballs, snow and ice, are all produced when water freezes. At what temperature?
100... No, no.
No, wrong answer. You can have a go. I'll finish it. At what temperature does that happen?
Below zero.
0, 32. Below zero is fair enough. We'll give you 25 points, yellow team. Yeah! So the scores now, 75 reds, 125 to the yellows. Okay, it's that time again for the girls to bring on the carts for the Fun Car Grand Prix. If you fancy 3 laps around our track, you're in the right place to start your engines. So, here we all are. The helmets are all ready to go. They're nice and safe and they're ready, as I say, for the Fun Car Grand Prix. That is 3 laps under and around our funhouse. Now, on the first lap, guys and girls, you've got to go for these tokens. They're the green ones. They're on the top of our poles. They're worth 10 points each, okay? Make sure you put them in the seat of your fun car or they don't count. Second lap, 25s. They're whites. That's what you get on the second lap around. Last lap, Leave the tokens, just go for sheer overtaking and go for that flag and the line and try and get first across it, because that's also worth 25 points. All right, who's going to go first then?
Me, Pat.
Okay, so it's a little bit of a duet there from the guys. They'll be leading the way doing laps 1 and 3, the girls in the middle laps 2, changing wheels after each lap. Let's get the racing underway. Come on, to the fun cards. Are you ready?
Yeah!
All right. So the scores stand at red 75, yellows 125. On your marks, get set, go! Yellow team lagging behind. Come on there. 25 points, Lee and Aaron. Well done. Well, let's see if you and Eve can catch up now as we count out the yellow points. First of all, a cough and a splutter from Martina because she's worried about the scores. It's been a draw so far, hasn't it? 10, 20, 30, 40. And we have a selection of weights for you at 25 each. 25, 50, 75. Total score, 240. Very good. Okay. Now here come the legendary Mean Greenies. 10, 20, 30, 40. And here's the whites. 25, 50, 75, 100. Total score, 240. It's a draw! Now, this is something that's never, ever happened before. On all three series of Funhouse, there's never been a draw. So what do? Give you all a run through the Funhouse? No, we ask you a deciding question. So, one hand from one girl, one hand from one boy. By the side, stand by, all right? It's the first one to press the buzzer and get this one right. At what number Downing Street does the Chancellor of the Exchequer live? Yellows. 11. Sorry?
11.
11 is right! You're going into the Funhouse! Yeah, you've done it! Now, I guess you were probably thinking as well, at what number of Downing Street? And you were all saying 10, 10, 10, but no. The whole question was Chancellor of the Exchequer. That's number 11. Reds, you don't go away empty-handed. You played well. You were brilliant. There's a Funhouse camera each. And also, what Melanie's beautifully modelling. You get the bum bag. You get the jacket. You get a hairdo. You get the lot.
Have a nice week. You were brilliant.
See you later on. Bye. See you later. Well, you're the clever clogs. You're the ones who are going in. You're excited. You want to know what's in there, yeah?
Give our camera a smile then. Say, what's in there, Pat?
We can tell you. Gary can. You can come and join us.
Better through the balloon tunnel to pick up some wonderful walking boots. And ticking away in the engine room is a real pipeline of a clog. If you amaze us all in the new net maze, this basketball set could be yours. And the pot of gold has you safe and sound with some super cycling gear. The temple holds the secret to these electronic games. Then tangle with the python to release and grab the mini TV. Behind the Aztec wall is a MIDI system you'll treasure, while the prize of the slalom slide is a book token to break your fall. Snuggling in the snowdrift is a super soft sleeping bag, and you'll need a backhand to win our badminton racket, but then dry off as you travel through these wibbly wobbly letters. A dynamic outfit is dazzling in the volcano, and deep below in our lava flow is a box of stamps for all. You'll have to master the masher if you want the mystery of our tour, and then untangle the tricks of our test tube tag to reveal the final swing ball game.
So then, even you and the Stanford Yellows, that's the list of prizes inside the Funhouse. 15 prize tags that look like this, one of them containing the secret power prize. Gary King knows the details. Gary?
The most up-to-date science video library, plus your very own TV and video player.
Wow, what a power prize, eh? What a power prize. Can't be about that. I thought you'd gone to sleep for a minute. Sorry about that. Okay, well, we know what it is. Let's see where it is, shall we? Okay, so people at home know where it is, but you and you don't. And neither does me and her. They don't tell us, do they?
No.
Nah. However, when you go inside the funhouse, you'll be grabbing prize tags to get the power prize. You won't know which prize tag it is until you hear this noise. And you won't win the power prize until you come down out of the funhouse and you answer the three-part question inside 10 seconds with a bit of conferring. So you'll be able to whisper inside each other's hats. You're like Teenage Mutant Hero Turtles in these, don't you? Excellent. Okay, so all you've got to do is get your feet on the steps and inside 2 minutes grab as many tokens as you can. Who'll be going first?
Me, Pat.
Oh, all right then. So you get your feet on the steps first. The funhouse has started. You grab three tokens, you come down, you high five.
Yo! Woo!
Then that means it's the changeover point. It'll be your turn to get three, okay, Eve? And the Stanford Yellows are going to do real well. I've got a feeling here. You may not get all 15, but get as many as you can, and we'll double it up. So if you pull out a squash racket, we'll make sure that you get one of each, okay? Squash them together. Stand by. Ewan kicks it off for the Yellows. On your marks, get set. Fun house! As you can, and let's add up those tokens and see how we got on. All right, right. This is the big moment here. Quite a lot. Come on, come close. Come close. This is the good bit here. Okay, you have got a basketball set each. Okay, which is real good news. You've also got the pipeline clock, the MIDI system. Ooh. The denim outfit each. The electronic games. The cycling outfit! And the mini TV, which will make up for the consolation that you didn't get the other TV, or the Britannia videos, or the video recorder, because you didn't get that power prize tag. But you had a good time, didn't you?
Yeah.
Did all right, and a good chase through the funhouse. Hope you enjoyed watching us. We enjoyed you watching. See you soon. Bye-bye! Yeah!
There's fighting talk and fighting action tonight on Challenge. The TNA crew are back and they're fighting fit from 9.
The Great Basketball Playoff, starring Ronald McDonald.
Now, Chicken McNuggets!
And Ronald makes the first basket. Now the McNuggets make a basket. The score's all tied up and the crowd's going wild. Ronald moves in for a dunk.
Barbecue sauce, McDonald's barbecue sauce here.
Oh. And the McNuggets go for a dunk.
And you didn't even dribble.
You know the one, McDonald's, food, folks, and fun.
Got my skis shined up and a stick of juicy fruit. The taste is gonna move ya. Take a sniff, pull it out. The taste is gonna move ya when you pop it in your mouth. Juicy fruit is gonna move ya. It chews the salt, it gets right to ya. Juicy fruit, the taste is gonna move ya.
Tonight, Bart will attempt the ultimate stunt.
I'm gonna leap over Springfield Gorge on my skateboard.
Cool! On The Simpsons, tonight on Fox.
Made in hell. Match made in hell. Special guest referee assigned, Sid Justice. Which way do you think he's going to be leaning, Anvil?
Well, Gorilla, he's a big dude. I don't know if he's going to be leaning a little bit this way, a little bit that way. All I know is nobody is going to push this big dude around. Nobody.
You got that right.
Well, in my opinion, Sid,
nobody wants your opinion. We've got action. We've got excitement lined up. So let's get to it. Here we go.
Slaughter in a handicap match, and the uncrowned Intercontinental Champion, Bret the Hitman Hart.
You wish, and you better go hide under the beds, because Paul Bearer is bringing out the Undertaker. We're gonna have more on Jake the Snake and the Ultimate Warrior. We're going to the cemetery. Also, the Rockers, tag team specialists on hand,
and close to one half ton, maybe over a ton, the Natural Disasters.
Let's not wait a moment longer. Let's go to ringside.
They're not going to be cheering like that for the Hitman.
I wouldn't be too sure of that.
You know, let me tell you something. Wait till you hear this news. This Monday night on primetime, Vince McMahon, Rowdy Roddy Piper are throwing a bachelor party for Macho Man Randy Savage. They're going to have the Bushwhackers, Mean Gene Okerlund. Vince McMahon will be there. Rowdy Roddy Piper and Sensational Sherry. And there is the fly in the ointment. Because, you know, Sherry and Savage used to be an item. And you think she's going to let him enjoy a bachelor party, marrying another woman? Who invited her?
Well, I did.
You did.
That's my show.
You watch Monday Night. You watch what happens. I'm going to love this. I love parties.
Sure, it didn't cost you anything. Somebody else is picking up the tab.
Chance I could win a door prize. You never know. Maybe there'll be a beef.
You may be the door prize.
Money could fall out of people's pockets. A lot of good. stupid things can happen to me. Let's get back to the match, Rizzo. Look at the Hitman. Look what great shape he's in. Oh, he's in great shape. There's no doubt about it. And he's probably the closest physically and technically and size-wise and speed-wise and everything as Mr. Perfect. But he's not perfect. You got to understand that, Andy. He could be in just 2 weeks. He could be the new reigning Intercontinental Champion, as the ring announcer in Madison Square Garden says so.
Well, and, a lot of people feel the way I do, Brett.
Well, that's immaterial right now. But Brett the Hitman really going to work on Ed Moretti here.
Did you ever consider, as a journalist, just writing things?
Oh, yeah, I have a column.
And not speaking at all?
Oh, no, I have to do both. The public demands it. The Hitman, known for his excellence of execution, just like that backbreaker right there. He'll be depending on that August 26th. Earlier on, we had a chance to talk to him.
It's only 2 weeks away, and this is an opportunity of a lifetime. Mr. Perfect in the SummerSlam, and I'm going to take the Intercontinental Championship belt. Mr. Perfect, I'm not coming away empty-handed. I'm going to take your title.
20,000 plus could be screaming the Hitman's name in Madison Square Garden. And 25 million at home could be screaming, Mr. Perfect did it again.
It's possible.
You know something, Gorilla? Sometimes not being perfect is good, too.
Oh, absolutely.
You should know, being not perfect. Here it comes. Sharpshooter. Cinching on it. Once he turns it over, forget about it. If you've got a counter for that, you better use it by now.
Call your chiropractor, baby.
Yeah. The counter is, don't let him get you in it. You got 2 weeks, dummy. Enjoy it. But then it's all over, Hitman. Hitman right on top of his game with just 2 weeks to go to SummerSlam. I like his chances.
Hitman off the ropes. That's the clothesline. Wow! Face to face, baby. Yeah. Neckbreaker. A lot of power there. Hitman's on his way to the Intercontinental Championship belt, baby.
Special report, here we come.
Good luck, you'll need it.
Hello, everyone. Last week on Superstars of Wrestling, my colleague, Mean Gene Okerlund, had the occasion to interview the Ultimate Warrior and Hulk Hogan, who will combine their talents as a team to go against the Triangle of Terror in a match made in hell at SummerSlam. During this interview, he introduced Sid Justice, the special referee for this handicap match. Let us see what transpired.
There's a nice start there with those guys. Whoa!
Sounds like a book by its cover.
Justice, I recall recently when you came out and talked to Sergeant Slaughter and company, and they tried to persuade you to be part of the Corps of Destruction, Sergeant Slaughter's Corps of Destruction. General Adnan, Colonel Mustafa, and Sergeant Slaughter himself. At the conclusion of that interview, you emphatically denied that you would have any association with Sergeant Slaughter's Corps of Destruction. However, what I've seen here this week, this may not be a handicap match in SummerSlam after all.
What are you trying to insinuate, little man? That I might be partial to this man who I might believe in. Yeah, I might not. And this man who shows me intensity almost at the same level as Sid Justice. But everybody can be assured of one thing. At SummerSlam, I will be there for one reason, and one reason only. To see that Justice is sired.
Following those bewildering proclamations by Sid Justice, the Ultimate Warrior and the Immortal Hulk Hogan had these comments to make.
You know something, little warriors and little Hulkamaniacs?
With the recent turn of events, me and the Ultimate One have read the question marks in your eyes. But let us reassure you little dudes with some straight talk right now. We know the rules. We know it's three against two. And we know what kind of rules Sergeant Slaughter and his troops play by. And as far as this new turn of events with Mr. Sid Justice saying he's going to call it 50-50, me and the Ultimate One have had a little talk about this thing. We know the power of Hulkamania. We know the power of the Warriors. And if something happens that Mr. Justice gets out of line one way or the other, he's going to be just another casualty of War Ultimate One.
Has anybody seen Mortal Hulk Hogan look you in the eye and done battle with you? Never! Except for one, the Ultimate Warrior and the Ultimate Challenge. Each and every time it's been a handicap. SummerSlam remains no different. You said just it, call it the way you see it. For there is no force, no person, no normal that can deal with the bond that we have. If you should elect to become a casualty of such a war, then let it be. Lay as a skeleton, for what is you, Sergeant Slaughter, you, Colonel Mustafa, you, General Adnan, you, Sid Justice, gonna do when Hulkamania and the Ultimate Warrior ride all over you?
I'm saying something.
More?
Every day across America, people share a smile with M&M's.
M&M's can, oh, M&M's can.
The milk chocolate melts in your mouth, not in your hand.
So have a handful of smiles.
My boy's a solar-powered perpetual motion machine. Don't think he'll go to sleep before he turns 18. We slow down for life, but not for long.
Why do your kids deserve Likes hot dogs? Because they're your kids. That's why.
They grow up so fast, the nice kids belong. Just like Likes, they're gone.
It won't kill you to go out with him once. You're not getting any younger, you know.
My head.
And he's a very successful mortician.
Where's my Anison 3?
To relieve a splitting headache, reach for Anison 3. It's strong, and Anison 3 is 100% aspirin-free.
Glad you're feeling better. Cecil's here.
Anison 3, aspirin-free pain relief for splitting headaches.
Hulkster and the Warriors, if they didn't have enough to think about, with Slaughter and company standing by waiting impatiently for SummerSlam. Now they've got to worry about which way Sid Justice is going to go, and they're claiming if he doesn't go down the middle, then it'll be four against two.
Well, let me ask you this question. Do you really think Warrior and Hogan are going to get along? I don't. I think there's a lot of animosity still there.
I think they will get along just fine, don't you, Admiral?
Animosity, schmanimosity. They're going to get along.
Army can be run over by Hulk Hogan, Ultimate Warrior. You could even throw in Sid Justice.
Serious? Take a look at Mustafa. Take a look at Adnan. There's your handicap right there.
For who?
For who?
Are you?
For Sergeant Slaughter.
Oh, you're nuts.
Wait.
Don't get out of your chair.
I'll get out of the way.
No, I'll let you out of it. Make him sit down.
You think these guys aren't worried? I'll show you just how worried they are. Earlier on, before the match, we had a chance to talk to Slaughter and company. Listen to these words.
Ultimate Cube, and you, the Immortal Slime Hulk Hogan, SummerSlam. My trio has no plan B. We're going all the way with plan A, and you're going to finally look into the eyes of the devil.
Brain and the inflection in Sergeant Slaughter's voice. If there's any dissension in the ranks, it's within those ranks.
No, they get along. They know their rank. They know where they belong. They know who's the leader. They know who's the general. They know who's the warrior out there. They know who's going to do all the combat. Hogan and the Ultimate Warrior, all they're going to be doing is trying to get in that spotlight. And who knows what Sid Justice is going to do?
Nobody.
Nobody. I doubt if Sid Justice knows.
It'll all happen in the special handicap tag team match at SummerSlam, exclusively right now on pay-per-view.
This is more tickets left, Brian. I know, and this is a handicap match here. Slaughter against two Hammond Eggers.
Slaughter will certainly have a much tougher time at SummerSlam.
I'll show you how tough this man is. In the usual handicap match, one stays on the apron, they tag in. He's asked for both these men to be in the ring at the same time if they want. And look at the number he's doing on these two guys.
Two relatively inexperienced newcomers here in the World Wrestling Federation against former WWF champion. What kind of results do you expect, Brain?
Well, there's
you expect these kind of results in SummerSlam? Forget about it. You want? It's Anvil's turn.
I'm not talking.
You won't let him get a word in edgewise here. Go ahead, Jim.
You know, I'll say one thing about Sergeant Slaughter. This man has got a lot of endurance. You don't see him huffing and puffing out there.
Anvil clutch slapped down. This youngster's already quit. Come on, ref. Ring the bell.
Nobody cares about my feelings.
What are you mumbling about now?
I happen to be a broadcast journalist. You two sit over there and beat your lips to death. People tune in to hear what I got to say.
Speak.
Okay.
I won't interrupt. Speak.
Forget it.
Can you speak without mumbling, without stuttering?
Well, Norman Bates over here is laughing. You keep interrupting
Norman
me.
Let me back up a little bit here. Let you guys get at one another. Slaughter just eliminated half the opposition. Now slapping the camel clutch on the other half. One guy already put away. Here's number two. Come on, ref, bring that bell.
Do you have any breakfast cereal? I hear something going snap, crackle, and pop.
Match is over.
You can do whatever you want.
You mean you can do whatever you want?
You let Jake put the snake on people. He can do whatever he wants. Duggan gauge you with a 2x4.
Another camel clutch being applied by Mustafa. As Sarge goes to work with the munitions belt on the other end. Oh, this is ridiculous.
A double camel clutch. You don't see that much.
Ruthless. These three are ruthless.
A lot of bravery shown on the part of Colonel Mustafa.
It is you, Warrior! SummerSlam! It is you! Ultimate Warrior! Immortal Slime!
No doubt the Triangle of Terror in peak condition for the match made in hell at SummerSlam 2 weeks from this Monday night, August 26th. And it is going to be a tremendous night for tag team competition. We have just learned here in the event center of another great battle. Six-man tag team competition will feature the Warlord and the Power and Glory taking on the Dragon, the Texas Tornado, and the British Bulldog. And you can see every exciting moment live on pay-per-view. Also, the Bushwhackers, they will be accompanied by Andre the Giant when they collide with the Natural Disasters.
Right here, Madison Square Garden, New York City, SummerSlam, bigger, better, and better than ever. Why? Because it's the Natural Disasters debut, baby.
Andre the Giant, you're looking for some revenge for what happened to your knee. Well, now is not the time to do it. You should not be trying to interfere in our tag match against the Bushwhackers. If you try to interfere, you very well may have a double disaster.
The big man hit the big apple, the Natural Disasters. Bushwhackers, Andre the Giant. The weather looks real bad in Madison Square Garden. Better up your disaster insurance, because when the disasters come rolling over you, there won't be enough left to pick up.
The Natural Disasters, Earthquake and Typhoon set for this giant confrontation with the Bushwhackers, Andre the Giant at ringside. IRS, he battles Greg the Hammer Valentine. Let's get more from the Hammer on this matchup.
Talk is cheap, Mr. IRS man. Erwin R. Scheister, as cheap as those spectacles and as cheap as that suit you wear to the ring. The first thing I'm going to do is tear those suspenders off and make you wrestle like a man. Wear a pair of wrestling tights, and then I'm going to give you the wrestling lesson of your life. You know something, IRS man? I might just use you in SummerSlam 91 as a personal write-off for Greg the Hammer Valentine.
SummerSlam, the hottest pay-per-view event of the summer, sizzles into your home live Monday night, August 26th. It's a match made in heaven and a match made in hell. It's SummerSlam. Call your local cable company for availability.
The flames of anticipation growing more and more intense. It's all happening at SummerSlam, 2 weeks from this Monday night, August 26th, live on pay-per-view.
Hey, dude, for the yearbook picture Friday, how about these?
Yeah, how about these? Couple of beauties. Immortalized in the yearbook.
You've got time.
Time to what?
Oxycute 'em.
Yes, Oxycute pimples with OxyPads. Watch through the microscope as Oxy's powerful medicine breaks up zit-breeding oil, so you can wipe it out of existence with your OxyPad.
Oxycute 'em.
The newest wave in writing.
Given the extraordinary, ever-changing selection on our all-you-can-eat Fresh-tastics food bar. Who says you can't please everyone?
Enjoy our ribeye steak dinner with bread and potato, only 99 cents when you purchase our all-you-can-eat Fresh-tastics food bar at Bonanza.
Officially, we don't know what the heck it is.
All I can say about this, it feels good.
Ladies, chill out.
Yeah. You could poke someone's eye out like that.
Yeah, the rats, they're having fun. Warm California sun.
The following.
Tremendous ovation coming up here for the tag team specialists, the Rockers.
You would. I like the pink.
Boy, these guys, Gorilla, they can really move fast together. They work well.
They certainly do. That's why they're called tag team specialists. Talk about guys moving well. The Macho Man will be moving well August 26th. Madison Square Garden, the big one, the match made in heaven.
Well, love it. This Monday night, like I said, on primetime, there's going to be a big, big bachelor party for him thrown by Rowdy Roddy Piper and Vince McMahon. Bushwhackers will be there, bringing their great table manners. Mean Gene Okerlund and Sensational Sherry, my personal escort for the evening. Champagne, caviar, cake, party hats, favors, bands, music, dancing, songs, singing. What a party! I'm tired already.
Yeah, and you haven't even had it yet.
Just thinking about it. I love parties.
Will there be a girl coming out of the cake or something?
There'll be two girls coming out of the cake.
I doubt that very much.
You don't know what might come out of the cake.
I know it won't cost you much transportation for Sherry. She'll just use her broom.
I'm going to tell her you said that.
You tell her I said that.
I'm going to tell her you nodded your head too, Nanville.
Oh, I'm scared to death. I'm shaking like a leaf over here.
The Black Knight has raised the ire of Marty Jannetty, and now he's going to have to pay for it. Must be the White Knight. No, that's
right. What are you talking about? He hasn't even taken his hat off yet.
How often do you see the Bushwhackers take their hat off?
I can't tell if that's their hat or their hair sometimes. Big hunks gnawed out of it. I'll say one thing about the Rockers. They keep in shape. They work out hard together. But they're just a bunch of punks. Look at the way they dress. How gaudy.
Fair warning, folks. I'm telling you right now, pick up that telephone. Pay-per-view is the only way that you can partake of SummerSlam right now. Don't be calling and sending us letters saying we missed out, we were too late. I don't want to hear it.
Yeah, but some Elmer will be scratching his head at home saying, gee, I forgot which date that was. It's the 26th of August, stupid. If you want to see a spectacular history made in a week.
Look at this move! Oh, forget about it!
Well, I missed something. What happened? You had me turned around now.
Shawn Michaels with a high cross slam of his own partner, Marty Jannetty. Bingo, it was all over.
At least we don't have to see it again now that he's over.
Oh, yeah? We're going to see it again. Let's go back and take a look at the fabulous Rockers in action.
Shawn Michaels reverses him into the corner, throws his hat to the crowd. High drop kick right next to Shawn. Shoots up Marty Jannetty.
Available this Tuesday on newsstands everywhere, the latest edition of the WWF magazine, the Hulkster on the cover, along with the Ultimate Warrior SummerSlam preview. Don't miss it. Let's go back up the ringside.
Following contest.
A lot of negative reaction here from this capacity crowd for this guy.
Here it is.
Not hard to understand why. This guy? No. The Warlord.
It's a good close look
like Diver, the Slickster.
The Warlord has nicer looking hair than Mike McGurk.
With you,
serious. Here it is. The Warlord.
Warlord involved in SummerSlam, six-man tag team action. He's teaming up with Power and Glory. They're taking on the Dragon, the Texas Tornado, and the British Bulldog. What a six-man that's going to be.
Well, it's going to be a lot of muscle in that ring, that's for sure.
Oh, look at that power right there.
Hey boy, I can see right
I don't know how Warlord's going to be able to get along with Herc and Jerk, if at all.
You mean Hercules and Romeo Roma?
Yes, I'm sorry.
Better be sorry.
There might be a little conflict of interest there.
Just to come out that way.
It never does.
Big lineup, August 26th, Madison Square Garden, SummerSlam, match made in heaven, match made in hell, Intercontinental title on the line, tag team belts up for grabs, $1 million belt up as well, and somebody's going to the slammer.
You know, and in that big tag match with Legion of Doom and the Nasty Boys, no disqualification, no count out, there will be a winner.
Sort of spells disaster in my book for the Nasty Boys.
Well, I know one thing. You don't want to get the Legion of Doom upset. That's for sure.
Nobody gets out of that.
Wave goodbye. It's all over. More important stuff coming up right now. So let's go to the event center.
You look good with a hat like that, Monty.
Once again, the Warlord finds little resistance in singles action. Well, Monday night, August 26th, 2 weeks from this Monday evening at SummerSlam, the massive superstar is going to be facing some serious competition when he joins forces with the Power and Glory for a six-man tag team battle against the British Bulldog, the Texas Tornado, and the Dragon. Also live on pay-per-view, you'll witness the match made in heaven, the match made in hell, as well as the Nasty Boys defending the tag team belts against the Legion of Doom. No countout. No disqualification.
Nasty Boys and Jimmy Hart, the whole world's gonna see us kick your butt at SummerSlam. All the times you hit us with the helmet from behind. All the times you called us nasty sissies. Well, Nasty Boys, it's coming now. The whole world is gonna see us become the World Wrestling Federation champions.
Well, isn't that a fine how do you do, Nasty Boys? You got no DQ. You got no count out. You got no luck. You couldn't have. You're stepping in the ring with us with rules like that. That means we're going to get to you. The way we've been trying and gunning for you has been something that has possessed us for a long time. You're in trouble.
The Legion of Doom, Hawk and Animal, determined to leave New York City's Madison Square Garden wearing the tag team belts after meeting the Nasty Boys. Also, Bret the Hitman Hart, he will challenge Mr. Perfect for the Intercontinental belt.
Hitman Hart, I'll say it again, the excellence of execution. Yes, you are. And you're also from Calgary, Canada. And Canada's never had a winner at anything. And what you want to do is bring home the Intercontinental Championship belt. You want to represent the World Wrestling Federation as a champion? You're really good, Bret Hart. You're even great. But you're not perfect. There's only one Mr. Perfect, and you're looking at it.
SummerSlam, the hottest pay-per-view event of the summer, sizzles into your home live Monday night, August 26th. It's a match made in heaven and a match made in hell. It's SummerSlam. Call your local cable company for availability.
Feel the scorching heat of SummerSlam. Bring all the action home 2 weeks from this Monday night, August 26th, live on pay-per-view when it starts at 8 p.m.
John McGowan here. You know, it's only $68 or less anywhere Greyhound goes. Right, Val?
Right, John. But is there anything cheaper? $68 for the limo?
Yeah, right.
$68, that's my final offer.
Any luck with the cab?
Not here, man.
Your skate, $68.
Per foot.
Yeah, Greyhound is pretty darn cheap, but to be honest, some things are even cheaper.
For a little pop quiz.
Bad news!
Now Twix has chocolate fudge between the chocolate and that great cookie crunch.
Good news!
New chocolate fudge Twix. Another one of life's great kicks. Twix.
I found that prices are better at Food Lion. The variety is better at Food Lion. And I just like the people better.
People in Smyrna are comparing food prices.
And I went to Kroger's. And I spent $81 there, where I normally spend $73 here at Food Lion. I found that on the same items that I normally buy on a weekly basis, I saved $8 by shopping at Food Lion.
Hey, a polar bear with sweet tooth ate all my regular Eskimo pie, bummed me out, so I got new Sugar Freedom Eskimo pies. I figured no sugar, no bear. Oh, same delicious taste as regular Eskimo pie. Man, even I can't tell the difference. Neither can the bear.
New Sugar Freedom Eskimo Pie bars, cones, and sandwiches with a great taste of NutraSweet.
Take a look. SRO signs went out here early in Calgary. 20,000 plus on hand, Anvil. Every one of them loves you.
Oh, there are great people out there. It's a little chilly in the wintertime, but it's nice.
A little chilly? 120 below, a little chilly? Things could get very cold for the natural disasters in the month of August in the Big Apple, Madison Square Garden, as they're going to have to face the Bushwhackers with the big guy Andre in their corner.
Well, it's summer, and SummerSlam is here, and it's hot in August. I don't look for it to cool off too much.
A lot of scores to be settled in that one.
You know something, Gorilla? I'd hate to have to pay the grocery bill of the natural disasters, that's for sure.
Neither one of them looks like they missed too many meals, do they, Jim?
No. Smorgasbord time.
Well, 1 week it didn't cost Earthquake anything to eat. And all that snake meat.
Will you stop? You think it's funny, huh?
The size of that man. And he's agile. And he's quick. And he knows how to wrestle. He's very dangerous.
Hunk of humanity. First, they'll have to deal with the very unorthodox, not only unorthodox style brain of the Bushwhackers, but now they got the Bushwhackers upset because they did a number on them. You didn't need to do that to the Bushwhackers. They're ready all the time anyway.
Oh, yeah, they're off the wall. They'll fight you at the drop of a hat. And Andre the Giant's going to be in their corner. I'll tell you, the doctor that worked on his knee, put what, 80 stitches?
80-something stitches, yeah.
And all stapled up and pinned and everything. He took out pieces of bone. He better get his tools ready. I think he's going to have to do a little more work.
Boy, are they having their way with these two youngsters. Earlier on, we had a chance to talk to the Bushwhackers along with the big guy, Andre the Giant.
Natural disasters! It's going to be the finish of you in SummerSlam! The
Yeah, you better get some insurance, Jimmy Hart.
He's got all the insurance he needs right there.
Oh.
Two natural disasters. What's it say on the guy's face there? State pen?
I can't make it out, Brain. You're the journalist. Avalanche in the corner. That'll do it. Yep, won't be this easy on August 26th, I guarantee you.
Whoa! What force did he hit him with, huh? Nice little two-step.
That's a lot of weight coming down here.
They've already done about half a dozen moves that would put anybody away. They chose not to. They chose to just keep dishing out the punishment here. Another tag was made. Earthquake's not even the legal guy in there now.
Doesn't matter. Typhoon is. The tidal wave.
Two squashes at one.
You know, Monsoon, they say close to a half a ton. I bet you there's more than a half a ton in there.
It's not easy to take the same steps that a snake takes. But the warrior has begun. He has walked these same steps I'm taking now. Felt the earth beneath his feet, the very same dirt. I wonder how many times this tree has seen someone buried underneath the dirt. The warrior has felt the coldness of the stone. I wonder why Lion was buried there. The warrior's not taking these steps because he wants to. It's because he has to. To put the puzzle together, he's had to do the hardest thing any man could do. Trust me. Trust me. And he has done that. And he has learned. But you see, you might be wondering where the warrior is right now. You might say he's digging up the past. Yeah, digging up the past. There we go, my man. Exhume the truth that lies beneath the soil. Come on. Dig. Dig.
You, Snake Man, the only other one that walks living amongst the dead.
Come on, faster, my big man. Use those big, wide shoulders. Deeper. That's not gold, my man. We're both looking for. Here, give me that spoon. You don't need a spoon no more. Crack the shell, brother. He's there. He's there. Come on. Yeah, you got it. You got it. Come on, reach into the bowels of that. Pull it out. It's there. Ooh, that's nice, huh? Smells nice, doesn't it? Death is always great to smell, huh, warrior? Wait. Now. This is just the beginning. Trust me. If I've done you wrong, you listen to me, my man. Yeah, you listen. You see, now I must bury you with the same soil. Oh, the very same soil, my man. Bury your fear, warrior. That's what we must do.
I trusted you before, Snake Man. Before my gods, I trust you once again. Bury me, Snake Man!
Stand your ground, warrior! Stand your ground! There we go, huh? Just about do it. You know, by sunrise we'll know if you've passed this test, warrior. Even though the largest piece of the puzzle will be given to you on Thursday, huh? But for now, huh? Do you trust me? Do you trust me? Cast your eyes into the sockets of the dead so you can understand the visions of the living.
guy. He's making time fly. They're running with the big guy. And I'll tell you why. He's got the world at his knees. And he'll do as he pleases. And those big jeans he's got, he won't fit in the shot. He's living large, easily seen because he's living large, living large, Levi's big jeans, he's living large.
You may have noticed lately that lots of people are having considerable trouble walking and chewing gum at the same time. Perhaps it's because of the great taste of Trident, Peppy Original, Tangy Fruit. Bubbly Bubble. Trident. Good for your teeth and great taste, too.
Sales counselors will let you play with lots of different video cameras and accessories. And when it comes to making sure you find the one that makes everybody happy, you'll find that they're some of the smartest, most helpful people in the business. How do we know that? We've got it on tape.
Ladies and gentlemen, I've got to address it before we get to the SummerSlam report. I cannot believe Jake the Snake Roberts certainly going above and beyond the call of duty to assist the Ultimate Warrior in overcoming the trepidation of the Undertaker. And I might add that the Ultimate Warrior is alive and well and prepared and then some for the ultimate test this Thursday night. Whatever that test may be, I cannot possibly imagine. Now then, SummerSlam is just 2 weeks away, and you can see it exclusively on pay-per-view. Get on the phone, contact your local cable company, and then you'd better batten down the hatches because it is going to be some kind of an extravaganza. During a red-hot summer, a red-hot match made in heaven. Oh, yeah. The nuptials between the Macho Man, Randy Savage, and the First Lady of the World Wrestling Federation, the lovely Elizabeth. From nuptials to napalm and a match made in hell. Earlier in this hour, we heard from all parties, Hulk Hogan and the Ultimate Warrior, and of course their opponents in this handicapped tag team bout, Sergeant Slaughter, General Adnan, and Colonel Mustafa. Very important we keep in mind the special guest referee is a man who said that justice will prevail, and he's going to see to it. I'm talking about Sid Justice. Folks, the Intercontinental title on the line. Bret the Hitman Hart is going to be challenging this man, the Intercontinental Champion, Mr. Perfect.
Let's not insult anybody's intelligence. SummerSlam, Bret the Hitman Hart. This is going to be the match to watch. The excellence of execution against Mr. Perfect. Add them all together, you come up with one thing. Mr. Perfect's a winner.
There's more. The World Wrestling Federation tag team belts are going to be on the line as the Nasty Boys defend against the Legion of Doom. No disqualification, no count out. There will be a definitive winner. Let's hear from all parties.
We're through with you after SummerSlam, L.O.D.
We suckered you right in. We got you where you want you. You're done, L.O.D.
Legion of Doom, this is your last trip to Nastyville.
Nasty Boys, what you got is no count out, no DQ, and no place to go but down.
That's right, at SummerSlam, nowhere to run, nowhere to hide. Your butts are ours.
In addition, the million-dollar belt is going to be up for grabs as the million-dollar man, Ted DiBiase, meets his former bodyguard, Virgil. I'm curious to hear what these two men have to say.
For 4 long years, Virgil, I totally dominated you. And in just about 2 weeks at SummerSlam, the domination will continue. Because nobody, nobody will ever take this from me.
Yeah, DiBiase, for 4 years, you made me do low, life, rotten, disgusting things. And the only way I can get even with you, man, is to beat you at SummerSlam and take that $1 million belt.
Can you believe it? A jailhouse match has been signed for SummerSlam. The Big Boss Man is going to be meeting the Mountie, and by the way, the loser of this one is going to be doing hard time. A night's worth. Let's hear from both men.
SummerSlam's only 2 weeks away, Mountie.
Boss Man, you spend your life in front of prison bars. Come SummerSlam, you're going to spend time behind bars. Hard time!
Mountie, jailhouse match, SummerSlam. You're going to find out what it's like to serve a night in jail and be treated like any other piece of trash. Be treated like the criminal you are and pay your debt to society, Big Boss Man style. Get ready to serve hard time, punk!
A couple of other matches we must make note of. The Bushwhackers, with Andre the Giant in their corner, will be meeting the natural disasters, Earthquake and Typhoon. There's more one-on-one. Greg the Hammer Valentine to meet IRS. You might say it's the figure four against the W4. I've got to tell you, I can hardly wait for that one myself. Ladies and gentlemen, we are two, count them, 2 weeks away. Think about it. Contact your local cable company and join us on a pay-per-view basis. Get ready for the match made in heaven, the match made in hell. It's SummerSlam, Monday night, August the 26th. Don't miss it.
It's summertime. Time to get out and get to the beach. And time for our grilled chicken sandwich at Wendy's.
Here's your grilled chicken sandwich, Dave.
Thank you.
Made Dave's way, with a boneless breast of chicken, lettuce, tomato, and honey mustard all on a toasted bun. It's a great way to enjoy the summer.
Hi.
Hey, Dave, how about some volleyball?
Cool.
Come in for a Wendy's grilled chicken sandwich today.
You sure this net's supposed to be this high?
Every day across America, people share a smile with M&M's.
M&M's can, oh, M&M's can.
The milk chocolate melts in your mouth, not in your hand.
So have a hand for a smile.
The salespeople were real dynamic. They knew what they were doing.
We saved over half.
We are return customers.
What these people are saying is all true. Mattress Warehouse and Brass does guarantee top quality, name brand bedding at the lowest possible price every day. Our staff is trained to know bedding. They're not part-time help. And on top of that, there's even a 7-way buyer protection plan to keep you satisfied. Mattress Warehouse and Brass, there's absolutely no reason to go anywhere else.
My mom saved over $200.
At last, you can love oatmeal. Because today, oatmeal is oatmeal Raisin Crisp.
Good! Raisin! Almond!
Oatmeal Crisp, oatmeal Raisin Crisp. Two ways to love oatmeal your way.
Look, Ma, I'm eating my oatmeal.
Ma, I'm eating my oatmeal!
Look, Ma, I found something for nothing.
Pop Secret Popcorn. Free and specially marked boxes of oatmeal crisp and oatmeal Raisin Crisp.
Be sure and write them a nice thank you note.
Available everywhere this Tuesday, latest edition of World Wrestling Federation magazine. On the cover, the Hulkster and the Ultimate Warrior. Inside, a most interesting article on Sid Justice, the Iron Hand of Justice. Make sure you pick up a copy.
Special SummerSlam edition, I understand.
Yes, it is.
It's scheduled for one fall. Currently in the ring, weighing in at 233 pounds.
You know what's going to happen?
From St. Louis.
They threw a turn on the Ultimate Warrior. What more could happen?
This Thursday. Get this now. This Thursday, Jake is going to take him one more final step. One more step. And we're going to see it here on Wrestling Challenge next weekend.
I think Jake the Snake has got to... Somebody put him to a little psycho job on him. I don't understand where he's coming from.
Well, he's getting the Warrior ready to handle the Undertaker. And only Jake the Snake with his cruel heart, his sick mind,
ain't working. Speaking of darkness and cruel minds, here comes two of them right here.
Boy, it gets cold in here, don't it?
Death warmed over himself, Paul Bearer, and The Undertaker.
He never takes his eyes off the ring, never takes his eyes off an opponent. Doesn't even know there's 20,000 people sitting here. That's intensity.
You know, Ambul, is it my imagination, or as they went by, did you get a whiff of formaldehyde?
I did. No, but I'll tell you, I've got chills off my body looking at this Paul Bearer's face. My God, your beard is standing straight out. It is a little erect, yes.
Extremely dangerous duo here, Paul Bearer and The Undertaker.
We'll do whatever is necessary.
I asked you that a month ago, and you being the outstanding journalist you claim to be, said, don't worry, I'll handle it.
I ask them, they won't tell me. They just look at me.
That's your job. They need to find out.
You take my job now. I don't like the look they give me.
Now he doesn't want his job.
When they look at you, they're not looking at you. They're measuring you.
Earlier on, we had a chance to talk with Paul Bearer. Here he is.
Wow, he's something.
Oh, yeah. Oh, Ultimate Warrior. If you continue your quest, searching for the source of my Undertaker's power, it could be very deadly.
That's it. I just got a clue. Whatever power this man has, like the warrior looks to the heavens for his warriors, Hogan's got his strength from the humanoids. Whatever he's got, whatever it takes, is in that urn. That's it.
The power of the Undertaker brain comes from that 6'10" frame and that 300 pounds of agility and power. That's where his power comes from.
Here's the tombstone. Look at this.
Wow! Being able to plant guys just like that.
Obviously, there is some kind of power, something in that urn that
there is.
There certainly is. You're right. What am I saying? He's right.
Things are probably empty. Here's Mike. Take a look at her.
I wish he'd bring two bags, one from McGurk.
Body bag time here in Calgary, Alberta, Canada. Got to be an eerie feeling in itself to be stuffed into that.
Well, I don't really think the guy knows where he is. It doesn't matter how eerie you think he may feel. He's out. It's got to be a very eerie feeling to have that zipper shut.
I guarantee you, the Ultimate Warrior knew where he was, and that dirt was coming down on his kisser, 6 foot down in the ground, and who knows what's going to happen to him next week.
Well, this Thursday, they're going to take that final step.
And next week, right here on Wrestling Challenge, we'll have that exclusive footage, whatever it may be.
This guy's going to wake up.
What? Listen to Paul Bearer. He never stops mumbling.
Is it some kind of a hymn?
I don't know. Look at him. What a piece of work he is.
It won't be like the party I'm having for Savage this Monday night. I guarantee you.
The event center is hot. Let's go to it.
It's in the bag.
According to champion Hulk Hogan and the Ultimate Warrior, victory will indeed be a matter of life and death. 2 weeks from this Monday night, August 26th at SummerSlam in the match made in hell. Also live on pay-per-view, you will witness the match made in heaven, the wedding of the Macho Man Randy Savage and Miss Elizabeth. And just announced, a six-man tag team battle, the Warlord and the Power and Glory will collide with the British Bulldog, the Texas Tornado, and the Dragon. Right now, that threatening threesome is standing by with more on this exciting match.
SummerSlam! The air will be electrified! The fire will be flying! And the muscles will be flexing, because we will take all of you down!
Warlord, Power and Glory, you're looking at the Texas Tornado, the British Bulldog, and the Dragon, the triple threat. You know something, you guys? You've got the power of the Bulldog, the wind from the Texas Tornado, and the fire from this Dragon. You will all burn SummerSlam
91.
Another encounter added to this great card, the Dragon, the British Bulldog, and the Texas Tornado to face the Warlord and the Power and Glory. Also, the Big Boss Man, he faces the Mountie in a jailhouse match.
Big Boss Man, in SummerSlam, New York City, Madison Square Garden, if you think you're going to send the Mountie to jail in that jailhouse match, you've got another thing coming, baby.
Big Boss Man,
They say before a big match, there's intimidation! Big Boss Man, the last time you saw the Mountie, I guess we could call it intimidated, can't we? I left you lying in the ring, foaming from your mouth, looking for some air to breathe! I've done half of the job. And SummerSlam, in this jailhouse match, I will finish my job! There will be no mercy! I have sentenced you to jail for life! And you will remember that I am the Mountie!
SummerSlam, the hottest pay-per-view event of the summer, sizzles into your home live Monday night, August 26th. It's a match made in heaven and a match made in hell. It's SummerSlam. Call your local cable company for availability.
There's only one way to catch every sizzling moment of SummerSlam. That is live on pay-per-view 2 weeks from this Monday night, August 26th, when it starts at 8 p.m.
All home equity loans are not created equal. The Money Store gives you a home equity loan so good, we guarantee it. Use the money for home improvements, college tuition, bill consolidation, anything at all. Or return the money within 14 days at no cost to you. For a home equity loan at a low fixed rate we guarantee you like, call right now. 1-800-LOAN-YES. The Money Store, where America goes for money.
Remember your four food groups.
Today we know to ensure good nutrition we should eat from the four food groups.
The four food groups.
The four food groups.
The four food groups.
Introducing Basic Four Cereals, a delicious blend of grains, fruits, and nuts that with milk gives you the goodness of the four food groups like you've never tasted them before. New Basic Four Cereals.
We have seen the future.
And it tastes great.
What gives Raisin Nut Bran such big-time taste? Is it the crispy bran flakes?
Wow!
The crunchy slivered almonds?
Ooh.
Or is it the
Raisin Nuts?
Yep, it's those enormous juicy raisins dipped in nuts that give Raisin Nut Bran that big-time raisin taste. And now for a limited time, there's a free pouch of those big guys in specially marked boxes of Raisin Nut Bran. Now with extra
Raisin Nuts!
Promotional consideration paid for by the following.
The WWF ring is...
Another outstanding lineup headed our way next week here on Wrestling Challenge in the Barbershop with Fruit Eye, the big guy, Sid Justice. And then this Thursday, it's going to happen. The final step, step three for the Ultimate Warrior. And we'll have that footage right here on Challenge next week. How about that ring?
How about this?
What is that?
This happens to be the real championship belt.
That's not Hogan's belt, Brain. I know the champ's belt when I see it.
You're right. Comparing this belt to Hulk Hogan's belt would be like comparing ice cream to horse manure. Comparing the men that wear these belts would also be like comparing ice cream to horse manure. You see, the man that owns this belt is right now under contract to another...